the Atlanta Falcons versus the San Francisco 49ers.
At Candlestick Park, it's a sellout crowd. More than 61,000 tickets were sold. The weather, San Francisco, a little overcast. The morning fog did chill the air, but not much. Hello, everybody. I'm Lindsey Nelson with George Allen. And, George, the Atlanta Falcons come in here. They're calling this a must game. How do you think they'll do about it?
Well, it is a must game, Lindsey. They have to win. If they lose, they're three games behind with only six to play. They have to win today if they're going to get back in the race. Now, the way the 49ers look at it is that they have to win. But what Atlanta has to do, they have to get the big plays and don't overlook the running game.
Speaking of the 49ers, they won six in a row. What do you think their plan will be?
Well, they don't have to do anything different. Sometimes you change after you've won a few. They have to throw the short passes, run just enough to take the pressure off of Montana, and they've got Fred Dean, something they didn't have in the first game.
And we're about ready for the kickoff now. It's got to be Atlanta kicking off. And the San Francisco 49ers have Bill Ring and Dwight Hicks back to receive. The kickoff of Luckhurst. Freddie Wyatt is the referee. There is his whistle. The left footer puts it up. And Hicks is waiting. At the goal line, Dwight Hicks. He's out to the 5. Hicks to the 10-15. Across the 20-yard line to the 22, where he's stopped by Kenny Johnson. So now it is the San Francisco 49ers with the football. Montana, the quarterback. Patton and Cooper, the running backs. Clark and Solomon are the wide receivers. Here's the offensive line. It's been a unit that's meant a great deal to the 49ers so far this year. First and 10 at the 22-yard line. Patton and Cooper in the I formation. Even them up. Cooper to the left side. Patton to the right side. Montana out in the right flat and incomplete out there to Freddie Solomon. It was Bobby Butler covering on that corner. Here's the three down linemen for Atlanta, Yates, Smith, and Formwina. Mara is expected to play some today. He would spell Formwina. He's been out with an injury. And linebackers, a fine linebacking core, Richardson, Kuykendall, Curry, and Williams back now off the knee injury, his second consecutive start. And Butler, Johnson, Glazebrook, and the pride of West Virginia D. Second down and 10 to go. The ball at the 22-yard line. Patton to the left side, and Cooper right, Montana retreating, and it is deflected and incomplete. Hoping for an interception was Bobby Butler diving. Fulton Kuykendall deflected the ball, and it's going to be third and 10 at the 22. Interesting that the 49ers have come out throwing here this afternoon.
That is, Lindsey. That's one of the things I just said at the top of the show. I think the 49ers have to run enough to take the pressure off of Montana. Now, on the first play, 23... Butler was laying off, playing a little deep, and Solomon was open.
Oddly enough, overall, San Francisco has run 54% of the time and passed 46% of the time this year. You think of them as a passing team, this is their third consecutive pass, trying to get a screen out there on the left of Ricky Patton, but he couldn't get close to it. And Joel Williams was covering out there, and pressure is being put on by linebacker Richardson, and here comes the punting unit on now, as the 49ers have gone to the air three times. And Jim Miller, the barefoot boy from Mississippi, is in there to boot it. His average, 42.4. Scott Werner from the University of Georgia is back there to receive the punt. He has replaced Reggie Smith, super net, as the return man. Booted out of there, good punt. Werner has it at the 28, 30, 35, and one into the 40-yard line. Good field position. Ethan Ramson. And that'll make the stop.
Nice return by Warner. He reminds me of a kick returner I had, Lindsey, named Eddie Brown. He's not a racehorse, but he handles the ball well, uses his blockers, and I like him.
All right, here's Atlanta's offense. Steve Bartkowski, the quarterback. Kanan Andrews, the running attack. Francis and Jenkins, the wide receivers. And there's the offensive line and the tight end, Junior Miller. They think a great deal of Mike Kim, that left tackle up there. And Howell is starting today at guard. That's awesome.
And Fred Dean is in there on first down.
First and 10 at the 40, and Dean is there. Normally he's in there on the pass rush, but he's in there at the start right now. The uses that power for 4 yards after the 44 before Jack Reynolds comes in to make the tackle. Now they're moving Jack Reynolds over to the strong side. Danny Buns is not in there. They're using Jack Reynolds on the strong side, and Craig Pukki has moved up.
Well, Reynolds prefers the strong side. That's where he's played a lot anyway, Lindsay. He's right at home because he's really a 43 defensive football player.
Reynolds and Pukki are roommates, both played at the University of Tennessee, 10 years apart. So now they're shoulder to shoulder as linebackers for the 49ers. Second and 44-yard line. Just now he was stacked up by Bobby Leopold. Here's the down three when they're in a three. Stucky Reese and Pillars starting in there today. And that is Harper, Reynolds, Pukki, and Turner in the linebacking core. But, of course, when Fred Dean is in there, that's altered a little bit.
They have four defensive ends in the ballgame right now, the 49ers. Strictly a pass rush.
Pillars, Stucky, Dean, and Boyd. Three wide receivers in there for Atlanta. Markowski. He was pumping it to Alfred Jenkins, and Ronnie Lott almost picked it off. Lott has intercepted 5 passes this year.
Let's watch Jenkins on this. A slant pattern, and he heard footsteps on that. He should have had that ball.
So John James comes in to do the punting. He's averaged 41.2. His long is 54. He's a 10-year man from Florida, and dropping back Dwight Hicks with Freddie Solomon to receive it for the San Francisco 49ers. These teams are sky high, and so is this crowd.
Well, this is a big game. These teams are very evenly matched.
Don James gets it off. Mike Hicks, he's at the 15. Bounces off one. Gets to the 20, 25. And it's picked up by Bob Glazebrook. So now the 49ers started first and 10. That was a 40-yard kick. It returned 12 yards. And when we get going here once again, it'll be first and 10 for the 49ers at the 26.
I can tell a real cowboy from the drugstore kind, clean across Texas. The way he works.
This telecast is presented by authority of the National Football League and is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the San Francisco 49ers and the National Football League is prohibited.
Lindsay, you mentioned that was a 40-yard kick, but it only had a hang time of 3.5, and that's why they could bring it back 12 yards on the return.
Spotted at the 27, first and 10. Montana up there. Cooper and Patton are his setbacks. Freddie Solomon in motion across. This is Cooper. He got 2 to the 29 before Fulton Kuykendall from UCLA came in to make the tackle. Second down and 8 yards to go.
Well, again, I think the 49ers, let's watch this play. Here's Joel Williams coming across. Pretty good block. Took him out.
Second down and 8 yards to go at the 29-yard line. Patton Cooper still back there. Quick pitch now to Cooper, trying to get him outside. He cuts back. Drives up to the 34-yard line before Jeff Yates came in to make the tackle. And here is the final score. Minnesota defeated Tampa Bay. That's a Central Division game in the NFC. The score was 25-10. That's final. And it was Houston 17, Oakland 16, and that's the final AFC game.
Well, that's a big win for Houston. A tough loss for Oakland.
Third down and 2 yards to go. It's Montana on a 3rd and 2 to Solomon. Incomplete, and Bobby Butler made his move and deflected. He's the rookie from Florida State who's had 3 interceptions this year.
Well, the ball kind of hung on that. Butler almost picked it off.
So the 49ers now have their second punt of the day coming up.
Lindsay, I'm going to repeat something I said. The 49ers have to run the ball just enough. They have to pick up over 100 yards on the ground so that Montana doesn't have to throw every down. That's what got him in trouble in Atlanta.
With Jim Miller back to punt, now Kenny Johnson is back to the team. Now he bobbles it to pick off a line drive. Kenny Johnson, the deep man, and it's going to be down. return, but there's a marker to be checked out. It's being reported to the referee, Freddie Wyatt.
It was a good snap from center. He just fumbled it. He did an excellent job of getting that ball off.
Ineligible downfield.
Here it is. Here, that's a good snap. It just went through his hands. Now he does a fine job of getting that off.
Only the outside men can go down. Freddie Wyatt will tell us about it, I think.
Ineligible downfield on the punt, number 80, declined, first down.
It is first and 10 as the penalty is declined. They'll have it at the 34-yard line. So we still have no score in the ball game. We're in the first quarter, and when play is resumed, the Atlanta Falcons will have it at their 34-yard line.
This is the famous Mason-Dixon line. North, south. And this is the famous Firestone Trax 12 radial. It's a tire for both sides. Up here, you like the fact that for as little as $42, you're getting an all-season radial. No putting on snow tires this year. Down here, you'll like the Trax 12 because you're getting a steel belted radial for your $42. But down here, no worries about the weather.
Radio Shack makes Christmas dreams come true.
Oh, I love the frog.
Cuddly animals with a radio inside.
Maybe Santa will bring it.
The bettable portable radios. A Pekingese and raccoon. A frog and a lovable floppy dog. And a cuddly cat or a cute brown spaniel. Furry friends in a musical menagerie that'll delight your kids or teens alike.
Daddy, Santa brought my frog from Radio Shack.
Only at Radio Shack, your Christmas electronics store.
Wednesday on Mr. Merlin.
Oh, Mr. Merlin, I'm sorry. I really blew it this
time. Pillars started in place of Dwayne Boyd as one of the three down linemen in today's game. That's Pillars, and Dean is on the sideline right now. Fred Dean is not in there at the moment on this first and 10 at the 34-yard line. Barkowski has them up there ready. Barkowski. And he is stopped at the 29-yard line. It's Tina Turner.
Well, you might think the protection fell down. It didn't. He had time to throw. Now watch this. Plenty of time to throw. Nobody is open. Now when he decides to throw, Tina Turner comes in from the backside. Everybody covered downfield. Good coverage.
Now on second down, Fred Dean is in there now.
He's going to be in there on passing situations. It's going to be interesting to see how Atlanta blocks number 74, Fred Dean.
He's made a world of difference in the defense of these 49ers. Second down and 5 yards to go. Annoyed. And Barkowski says it's too much. And so delay has been indicated. Delay of game is indicated, and that cost them five. It's here, Freddie Wyatt.
Delay offense.
I'll tell
second
you,
down.
Tell you what's happening, Lindsay, is the way the 49ers are using Dean. He is bothering Atlanta's offense. Their game plan is to make sure they block him and counter him.
By the draw play to Andrews. He gets 1 yard. Tina Turner again on the tackle for the 49ers.
What I used to like to do when they had a pass rusher like Dean, we'd trap him. Run draws inside of them. Run against them. Run against the nickel and the dime defense. Don't always throw against it because you're going into the strength. Now let's see how they block Dean this time.
Dean a fan from the San Diego Chargers by these 49ers. And he's been a valuable addition to their defense. Barkowski. Jackson incomplete. Alfred Jackson, the intended receiver. Eric Wright, the rookie on the right corner, made the move.
Right. Look what they did to Dean on this now. Dean ends up right in Barkowski's face. He takes an inside charge. Good penetration. You see that? He spins. He made him throw the ball off balance. The ball flutters right here. Nice defensive play by Eric Wright. But Dean caused that.
Bill Walsh, the head coach of the 49ers. John James is back for Atlanta in deep punt formation. Eddie Solomon is on his own 30-yard line to receive it, and they've got 10 men on the line of scrimmage. 49ers do. James gets it off. Eddie Solomon at the 29. He skids and he's at the 30. And he stops about the 33-yard line by Bob Blaisbrough. Well, it's a 47-yard punt. It's returned 5 yards. And when play is resumed here, it'll be first and 10 for the 49ers at their 33-yard line.
The criteria for a compact copier of a different sort. It's here.
America's truck. And now it's got a great options play going for it.
Save up to $795 off the regular sticker price on special Explorer pickups with options like two-tone paint, special interior, tilt steering, air conditioning, automatic transmission, and lots more.
You know, $795 off of this Explorer pickup is a big score in my book. It's a real bear for punishment, too.
America's truck. Built for tough.
San Francisco 49ers first and 10 at their 33, no score.
Lindsey, that last punt, 4.9 hang time. That's why there was no return. Good cover.
But Jeff Merrill, who is in the ballgame now defensively. Here's a long pass play, and it's pretty Solomon, and he can't hang on. It's incomplete. Butler covering. Pretty Solomon.
Lindsey, great call. He had him beaten. The ball was just a little short. Watch this. Play action, first and 10. Now Solomon is wide open. The ball is just a little bit short to allow Butler to get his hand in there and deflect it.
Solomon comes off now, and Mike Schumann has replaced him.
Actually, he had it and dropped it.
Second down play coming. Joe Montana. NFC's top-rated passer. Ready to take the snap of Schumann in motion across. Takes the draw. Montana guns, and it is Clark incomplete. He bounced it. Right Clark incomplete. Kenny Johnson on that corner, along with Tom Pridemore.
Well, here's second and 10. Fakes the draw. Now, this is the type of pattern that Clark runs real well. It's a stop pattern, and he drills it in there. He had it and dropped it. Should have been a completion on that.
You want to know what kind of start Montana's off to today, and he is the NFC's top-rated passer. He is 0 for 6. Third and 10.
I'm surprised neither team is running the ball that much. 49ers came out throwing every down.
Montana deflected. Oh, it was Buddy Curry. Got a hand on it.
Buddy Curry almost intercepted that. Again, it was a stop pattern, a possession type of pass, and that's what the 49ers do so well.
Well, what we got so far is a punting duel. Washington in the fourth quarter leading Detroit 33-31. And a final score, Green Bay 26, the Giants 24.
Stener Road kicked the winning field goal.
Philadelphia 52, St. Louis 10 in the fourth quarter. Kenny Johnson is back to receive this pass from Miller. Barefooted Floyd boots it up there, and Johnson waits at the 22. He's got it. Gets across to the 26. Danny Bunn's downfield. He's on special teams now. So when they resume again on a 54-yard punt with a 4-yard return, it'll be first and 10, and the ball will be at the 26-yard line.
It takes two wheels to have some fun. And you need two more to get the job done. But what can you do
with an airplane with $200,000 that didn't belong to it? He was a dang fool.
It was great, Dad. It was great.
But he fooled everyone.
The person that turns him in is going to be a national hero. The
person that turns him in ought to be shot.
The Pursuit of D.B. Cooper. It's a true story. No fooling. Rated PG. Starts Friday at a theater near you.
Next weekend on CBS Sports Saturday, a battle of the undefeated. Knockout artist Aaron Pryor defends his crown against Duwan Johnson for the WBA Junior Welterweight Championship.
Aaron Pryor and Duwan Johnson, and they're both knockout fighters. Right here, we have no score, and it'll be first and 10 at the 26-yard line.
And Pillars is in there in place of Dean, so this is their run defense, so to speak. I think Atlanta has a heck of a running game, a very balanced offense.
Lehman Bennett and Bill Walsh. It's a chess game so far this afternoon.
Now they just sent Dean in.
That kind of day. They're switching defenses. Offensive tactic, first and 10 at the 26. Give it on the count to Andrews. William Andrews up to the 30-yard line for 4, second and 6. Here's the final score. Philadelphia 52 and St. Louis 10. The Eagles on top.
Vermeil had his team ready for that one.
Didn't he, though? Chicago Bears 13, Kansas City 6. Walter Payton is injured a leg, and that might not be back. That's the one we just saw, the Eagles. Tony Verner's our director. He puts the Eagles through up right now. Time again if they win big. Motion across. Penalty marker at the line of scrimmage by Kowski. Well, penalty marker on a grounding call. Red Dean got there.
Yeah. Watch Dean come off of the ball. Beat Kennedy outside. Put the pressure on Steve Bartkowski.
It's a procedure call against Atlanta, says Freddie Wyatt.
You know what? When you put one man on Dean, what bothers a guy like Dean is to put the strong side to Dean's side. Put the tight end. Put the tight end next to Dean. Now he's worried about being blocked by the tight end. Or, Lindsay, the other thing is don't run away from him, run at him. See?
We had two calls. One at the line of scrimmage was the procedure, so it's an option now. And Lott is up there. Ronnie Lott from USC, a rookie, to exercise the option. Brady Wyatt had indicated grounding call back there as well. That's Ed Murray and the head linesman right there. Tom Hensley is the umpire in your picture just there. So as soon as it has been enforced, Freddie Wyatt will tell us about it. Coming right here.
Intentional grounding, number 10. Declined, third down, lost the down.
Now, let's see on this down. See, Mike Ken's an all-pro, in my opinion. There's no better tackle. So they got their best offensive lineman on Dean. They still have him on the weak side.
Third down, about 16. Three wide receivers in there. However, they leave it on the ground to Andrew. He gets it up there to the 25. It's going to be 4th and 11, and the punting unit comes on.
Well, they ran at him, and Dean is running a stunt here. He's going inside. They're running what you call a Rex. And so Ken just eats him up on that play, but, of course, they had too many yards to go.
Freddie Solomon and Dwight Hicks have dropped back to receive the punt of John James. It's been a punting ball game so far. No score, first quarter, 8 minutes, 16 seconds left to play in this period. No groundskeeping done by Freddie Wyatt, the referee. Long, high, spiraling, John James kick. White Hicks is back at the 22. 25 is the penalty marker. He slips down. There's a marker to be checked out. It was Tony Dakin who was out of tagging. Saw the referee toss the towel aside. The officials today, Freddie Wyatt's the referee, the umpire's Tom Hensley, the head linesman's Ed Marion, the line judge is Wilson Gozier, back judge is Dick Hantak, and the side judge is Vince Jacob, the field judge is Bob Wartman.
Lindsay, what's taking place is the 49ers defense is dictating to the Falcons offense to some extent. They're substituting defensive ends, Dean primarily, in different situations. Now, the last time they waited until very late and brought in Dean after the Falcons had called their play in the huddle.
Let's listen to Freddie Wyatt.
Illegal block below the waist. First down.
We talked to Steve Bartkowski before today's ballgame about Fred Dean that you've been watching here just lately. And here's what he had to say.
Well, we don't anticipate all that many problems from Fred. I know he's a great player, and that's not taking anything away from him, but we've got a pretty great player blocking him in Mike Ken. So we're just going to go into the game thinking that we can do what we've always done until he shows us that we can't.
Below the waist, first down.
Well, they got the ball straight out. Freddie Wyatt initially had gone the wrong way with that penalty yardage, so now it is first down, and it's 10 yards to go. The ball's at the 14-yard line. Still no score. Patton and Cooper, quick pitch now. Walt Easley. Walt Easley, who had just come in there, took the pitch.
Well, Lindsay, that's what I think the 49ers have to do. The first game, they couldn't run the ball very well. They got to be able to run the ball enough so that Montana can throw and not have a lot of pressure. Now, Easley, I've liked him. He's a hard runner. He's more of an inside runner, and he's a pretty good blocker.
Here's the final. The Redskins defeated Detroit 33-31.
Mark Mosley kicked the winning field goal there.
That's 97 San Diego nothing. That's in the first quarter. It's Easley again. Headed up there to the 23-yard line before Tom Pridemore came in to make the tackle. Joe Montana.
Well,
Don Smith just there, one of the better nose men in the
league. Yeah, you mentioned Montana. Their defense improvement, but Montana, from the beginning, we always liked Montana. He sets up quickly. He gets rid of the ball quickly. He's got a lot of poise. He's a veteran quarterback with the limited experience that he has.
Third and two at the 23. Double tight end. Got a reverse, and that's Freddie Solomon. Well, he's trying to get the first down. I think he got that. Pridemore ran him out.
Boy, that third and two, that's quite a gamble on third and two. Solomon did this on his own. Reversed to the flanker. His speed allowed him to pick up the first down.
At the 26.
He was trapped back there.
Solomon comes off the field now. Mike Schumann comes on to give Solomon time to get his breath. And it's Schumann in the wide right. Dwight Clarkson in the wide left. The running backs are evened up for Joe Montana. That is Laughlin. Easily. Out to the 34-yard line. And Bob Lathrop going to make the tackle.
Well, Easley shows his hard running, good leg action. A draw play, good body lean, picks up 8 yards. Now, this is the way I think they have to play to win today. Establish the running game first, then their short passing game.
Easley is a rookie from West Virginia, had a fine game last week against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Running side. Trying to pick up the first down yardage there, but short.
Yeah, well, with Davis out, Lindsay, Easley's going to get plenty of chances to play today.
Well, he certainly is. The 49ers hoped at the start of the season that Earl Cooper would be the man to run inside. They found out maybe that wasn't going to work out, so then they got Davis in Tampa Bay. They used him to run inside. He's out with an injury to his calf muscle.
Yeah.
That's Davis,
I think,
right?
Yeah,
there.
I think that was a good trade for him. They got him from Tampa Bay for Owens. Now they have two tight ends in there.
Third down. To go. And they got it. First and 10. Eddie Curry. And they make the tackle.
Well, Lindsay, the other difference in the 49ers is they're playing with a lot of confidence, aren't they? You can just see that as they break the huddle, the way they walk, the sidelines. They're a much more confident team than they were earlier in the year.
First down and 10 yards to go. At the 37-yard line. We have 4 minutes, 58 seconds left to play in the first quarter. There is no score. It's Denver 3, Cleveland nothing. That's in the first quarter. And it is the Pittsburgh Steelers 7, Seattle 3. That's in the first quarter. Right here, no score. First and 10 at the 37-yard line. Montana there. Good pitch to Easley. Jeff Morrow got to him. You saw Joel Williams trying to fight his way outside.
Yeah. Williams really made that play. He got across the line of scrimmage, did not stay blocked, 58. His penetration made the play, even though he didn't make the tackle. He set it up.
Second down and 8 yards to go at the 39. Montana takes a look around. Motion across. Joe Montana. That's not so easy. just about the 45-yard line. Joel Williams bouncing him out with Buddy Curry.
Well, here it is. Montana had sent Solomon in motion and was looking for Solomon downfield on Johnson. Johnson had him covered, so he dumps it off to Easley.
Third down, 2 yards to go, and Mike Wilson has come into the ballgame. Ricky Patton has come out. Here's an overtime at 27, Miami and New England. And 10-7, the Jets over Baltimore in the first quarter. Joe Montana. Price got it first down. First and 10 at the 49-yard line. Joel Williams covered.
There's a great catch. Montana knows he almost overthrew him. Great catch. Look at that. Right on the fingertips. You can't defense that.
Joe Montana came into this game having completed 63.9% of his passes this year. 12 touchdowns, 7 interceptions. From Monongahela, Pennsylvania.
Well, you know, the difference in this drive now, he's mixed his running and passing. And that puts the Falcons solely on defense.
Ricky Patton's back in there. He and Cooper, the setback. This is Cooper. Nothing. Al Richardson, linebacker, in on the tackle with Buddy Curry for the Atlanta Falcons.
Well, the Falcons were in the right defense. They dog on this play. See if we can see it. Kuykendall, 54. And Williams coming in. And boy, do those guys ever swarm around. Great gang tackling.
Second and about 14.
They don't stay blocked. That's the test of a good defensive player. You can't stay blocked.
Patton has come out the field. Mike Wilson, wide receiver, and there only one setback. Montana. Right front. First and 10 at the 25-yard line. Denny Johnson made the stop.
Well, Lindsey Clark was wide open. The Falcons don't make any substitutes on the nickel or anything like that. They came in with a three-man rush, pretty good protection. Watch him. He's in front of the secondary and behind the linebackers.
They picked up 27 yards on the play. It's spotted at the 26-yard line, first and 10. 3 minutes left to play in the first quarter. Clark out to the left side. Solomon to the right side. Patton and Cooper, the running backs, evened up for Montana. Play action fake. Long pass to Solomon, incomplete in the end zone. Bobby Butler covering on the corner.
Well, Solomon is open on this. He's wide open. A good pass. He's got to score. See that? He has Butler beaten. Overthrew him.
Second down and 10 yards to go as Solomon comes back to the huddle. Right at the point where the ball is now is the infield of the baseball layout here at Candlestick Park. And the sod has really not taken hold yet. So the ground crew has been going out to replace divots. And Freddie Wyatt, the referee, is replacing a divot or two right there now. Solomon has come off. Schumann and Clark are in those wide receivers. Double to the left side. Montana. Screen right. Cooper. Stopped at the 26.
Great play by Richardson. And Montana had the correct call. They came with a safety blitz. And you counter that with a screen pass. Here it is. They're coming in with a safety blitz. They're dogging. He's got a screen pass, which is a great counter. Now watch 56. Richardson. Beautiful.
It is third and 10 at the 26. Here's the final in overtime. Miami has defeated New England by a score of 30-27 in overtime. And in the first quarter, the Rams are leading New Orleans 3-0. Those are Western Division teams. He's across the 30 and goes out of bounds near the 35-yard line.
Well, Lindsey, what happened is 87, Dwight Clark fell down. It looked like he threw it right to Kenny Johnson because maybe we can see it. You were talking about the wet field. 87 slips and falls in a crossing pattern. See if we can see him fall down. There he is. And he throws it right to 37, Kenny Johnson.
So now Atlanta has the ball first and 10. They have it at their own 34-yard line. Dan and Andrews on the setback for Bartkowski. Andrews to the 36-yard line for two. It'll be second down and 8 yards to go. Lawrence Pillars in to make the tackle. Andrews came into this game having rushed for 754 yards, almost 5 yards per rush.
4.9, actually.
Red Dean is coming into the
play now. Here comes the pass rushers and the pass defense. Second down and 8. Now, again, I'll say the way to counter that is run at Dean. Don't run away from him. Trap him. Draw that type of counter.
Set it up in a slot left. Andrews. Got to the 42-yard line. Not enough of the first down. Carlton Williamson, who had such a great game against Pittsburgh last week, can help make the tackle.
Well, they're getting out of that muddy area. Well, but you see, that's prescription turf, and that is the same as RFK and the Dolphins have in Miami.
That prescription needs refilling. It's third down, 2 yards to go at 42. Bartkowski. Intercepted. Penalty marker goes down. It's Bobby Leopold, but there is a marker.
Well, he was throwing the ball to Lynn Kane, number 21. Great interception, really. He intercepted it on the ground.
That's Freddie Wyatt, the referee, in conclave with some of his officials as they gather around.
Mike Ken had Dean blocked on that last one, Lindsay. Did a good job on him.
That's the don't disturb sign that Wyatt has out there with his left hand. So let us talk this over.
Well, when the conference gets too long,
interference call against the 49ers, which will not be too popular with the 49er fans here at Candlestick. It'll be an automatic first.
Pass interference, number 52, defense, first down.
Leopold, man who made the interception call for interference.
Well, let's see if we can see Leopold, number 52, on Lynn Kane. Well, there was contact there. Looks like a good call.
Notre Dame man against the Southern Cal man. It's first and 10 at 46. Bartkowski putting it up for Alfred Jackson, but incomplete.
Well, Bartkowski had him open, but he's throwing off balance. He's throwing as he's retreating, and the footing is not such that he can get set and deliver the ball. He had him open on a corner pattern.
You know, speaking of Fred Dean, and you've been pointing out when he's coming in on the pass rush and that sort of thing, the Green Bay Packers tried to call a few plays in series without a huddle so that they could run him without Dean getting into the ballgame.
Well, what I used to do with Deacon Jones in this situation, I'd move him around. I'd play him at left end, right end, so forth. Well, there he is.
Yep.
He's moved over to left end now.
Fred Dean is playing defensive left end on this play. From Clemson.
Well, they're dictating somewhat to the Atlanta offense with the way they're substituting and the way they're moving Dean around. Very smart, tactical football.
Lehman Bennett, son of your picture there, 43 years of age in his fifth year as head coach of Atlanta, and Sam has run out in this period. As you see Bill Walsh, it is the end of the first quarter here at Candlestick Park, and the score is the Atlanta Falcons nothing, and the San Francisco 49ers also nothing.
I can't see a thing, Stan.
Did you turn on the windshield wipers?
Of course I did. See? No, I can't. Obviously, we need new wipers.
We obviously need new wipers.
Replace your old blades at least once a year with Anko, with specially formulated natural rubber for a smooth, clean wiping action.
That's a lot better, Ollie.
It certainly is. Let's drive on.
Not too fast, Ollie. Might be a school zone.
Excuse me. I'm not the same crazy coach who used to storm around the sidelines yelling at the officials. I've learned to relax, and I drink light beer from Miller. Do you know that Light's got a third less calories than a regular beer? And listen to this. Light doesn't fill me up. Besides that, Light tastes fantastic. Oh, sure, there are a lot of other beers around, and you can drink any one you want. But let me tell you this.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
As I was saying, I don't care what anybody else...
He was the kind of a guy who didn't expect much from today's small cars. Just practicality, nothing more. Then he saw the 1982 Oldsmobile Omega and realized he'd been expecting too little. This four-cylinder, front-wheel drive Olds Omega had style. He could imagine the luxury inside, the smooth, quiet ride. Olds Omega, he smiled. Even today, there's still room to do it with style.
Coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by Light Beer, everything you always wanted in a beer and less. And by Oldsmobile, who invite you to see the new 1982 Oldsmobile at your Olds dealer today.
San Francisco, this is Lindsey Nelson with George Allen. In the first quarter, Atlanta did not get into San Francisco territory. Atlanta had a total of 7 yards. San Francisco had a total of 67 yards. Atlanta passing in the first quarter 0 for 3, minus 17 on two sacks. It's third down, 11 yards to go. They have it at their own 45-yard line. There is no score, and Barkowski's waiting for the snap. He's got it. Incomplete. He hit Alfred Jenkins. And now, for an NFL Today report, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsey, it's 7:51 of overtime. The Miami Dolphins and Von Schaman set to attempt a field goal against the New England Patriots. From 30 yards away, Von Schaman has never missed in his career before, and he doesn't hear either. The Dolphins win in overtime. Back to Lindsey Nelson.
All right, Brent, the Dolphins with a big win in overtime, and right here we have a scoreless game. It is James back to punt. Solomon's back there with Hicks. He's over to Hicks' side of the field. Right, Hicks at the 7-yard line, drops the ball. Got it at the 5. Penalty marker goes down. He returns to the 7. Lane Dyson made the tackle.
There's more penalties on the kicking game than any other phase of the game, Lindsey. Most every kick, there's some penalty, there's some violation.
Freddie Wyatt's been a very administrative fellow here this afternoon, and we're going to get some more of it. Illegal use of hands, he says. And against the Atlanta Falcons, he says. Dwight Hicks, the fellow who had a little trouble finding the football.
On that last down, Mike Ken blocked Dean very well.
Dean put no pressure.
Rear, number 30, first down.
Well, it was against the 49ers, if it was against.
49-yard punt.
And it was against Bill Ring. And so when play is resumed, as you watch Bill walk, it'll be first down and 10 yards to go for the San Francisco 49ers.
I'll try almost anything. So when Mattel Electronics asked me to compare their Intellivision games with Atari, I gave it a try. I compared Atari baseball with Intellivision and found Intellivision played much more like real baseball. Then I compared Atari football with Intellivision. Again, Intellivision played more like the real game. In my opinion, if you try them both, there's only one conclusion you can come to. Intellivision from Mattel Electronics.
Presenting the new Toyota Supra and Dan Gurney. It takes the right stuff to make a great performance car. Come ride with Dan Gurney and see.
It's quick off the line. That's the twin cam fuel injected engine.
Ex-CIA agent selling Gaddafi arms and terrorism. How deep does the CIA Libyan connection go? A special report on the CBS Evening News.
You look at Joe Montana, who was an outstanding quarterback during his college days at Notre Dame. has taken over as the quarterback here for the 49ers. He has the ball first and 10 at the 4-yard line. It is the sixth consecutive game in which the 49ers have not allowed their opposition to score in the first quarter. Ricky Patton, stopped by Jeff Morrow, out of the 10-yard line.
Well, that's what you have to do. You have to pick up at least one first down in here so that you don't have to putt the ball out of the end zone.
Ricky Patton, four-year man from Jackson State. Came in with an average of 3.4 per carry and three touchdowns this year. And it is no gain as you stop at the 10. It'll be third and four. Pulling Kuykendall on the target. Paul Hofer along the sidelines. Now, Hofer, of course, had the knee surgery in the offseason, was slow coming back this year, got back and was a big boost to their running game, and has been injured again.
Well, they still need him. He's a fine all-around football player, a great receiver, Lindsey.
We're told that he might be able to play. Yes. And he looks like he's ready along that sideline if they leave it up to him.
You know, Atlanta has Glazebrook playing right up on the line of scrimmage in a running situation like another linebacker, number 36. Atlanta went double coverage on the wide receivers. In 87, Clark just hooks up in there. Now watch it.
Here comes Hofer.
There's an open seam there. First down.
Paul Hofer is coming to the ballgame. Ricky Patton has come out. First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
Talked about Hofer being a good receiver, but watch the job Montana does on this. He's rushed. He just lays it right over the defense. Fingertip catch. Hofer picks up the first down. He comes out of the ball game. One for one.
One for one and 21 yards on the play.
Here it is. Nice throw. Nice feathery catch.
Hofer's out. Ricky Patton's back in. First and 10 at the 42-yard line. No score in the game as yet. We're in the second quarter. But he's found the motion across. Ricky Patton fumble. Campbell is on at the 45-yard line. So they sort it out.
Well, they have a debate down there.
Ball got away from Ricky Patton, recovered by the 49ers.
Let's see it. Patton's trying to dodge. He fumbles. Now it's a question of who has it or whether they blew him dead. Smith came off the field. He thought the Falcons had the ball.
The hit that caused the fumble was by Buddy Curry, the linebacker.
They're still debating this.
Pittsburgh 14, Seattle 3 in the second quarter. And it is Cincinnati 10, San Diego nothing. That's in the second quarter. Second down play coming here. That's what they were getting straightened out.
Now, Hofer just came in with a play. You have to defense him when he comes in. He's always involved.
Second and 7. That's the 45. Joe Montana. Incomplete to Freddie Solomon.
Well, he had Solomon open on a stop pattern, but the ball was thrown low into the ground. It's hard to get any footing here to throw the ball. There's a little swamp there.
Murrow goes off. Farmawina comes back on. Farmawina from Balboa High School here in San Francisco was drafted out of San Jose State. Montana they're covering. Fourth down coming up. The punting unit's coming out.
He had him open. He split the defense, but the ball was thrown high and behind him.
So once again, barefoot Jim Miller comes out.
He's had the protection, Lindsey. Montana's had pretty good protection.
Ken Johnson is back deep to receive it for Atlanta. Earlier in the year, Supernat Reggie Smith had those duties. Off the side of the bare foot, but he gets a good roll. Some cattle roll down to the 13-yard line where it's out first and 10. So when play is resumed now, Atlanta has the ball. They have it in their own territory. First and 10 at the 13, and there is no score.
GMC is a big name in trucks with a lot behind. And GMC's new S15, the little rig with a standard 4 or available with an optional V6 engine that can deliver economy and be quick about it. GMC, the name tells you right up front, trucks are what we're all about.
Some house, but you need a new heating system.
Gas is not.
We heard wood stoves were efficient.
Wood's not cheap.
There's oil. Can we use a fireplace?
How about steam?
You gotta have insulation.
I know electric.
Hold it.
So are heat.
Hold it. The first step is the Yellow Pages.
The Bell System Yellow Pages. The first step in helping you solve a heating problem. Before you waste time and money, take the first step. Let your fingers do the walking through the Bell System Yellow Pages.
Some storm.
The house is cozy.
Monday on Private Benjamin.
Can't even get a cab.
Judy finds a way to sneak everyone back in the cab, but she doesn't count on Captain Lewis driving. The last began Monday night.
Next weekend, CBS Sports Saturday brings you more great championship boxing as knockout artist Aaron Fryer defends his WBA junior welterweight crown against the determined Dewan Johnson. Be ringside for all the action. That's next week at 4:30, 3:30 Central and Pacific on CBS Sports Saturday.
Here's a hitter right there, and he's playing on the strong side where he wants to play.
Hacksaw Reynolds. Red Dean is in there as well. Nothing there.
And Reynolds stuffed the hole. He didn't make the play, but he stuffed the hole to allow somebody else to make the play. That's his job. That's his responsibility.
Lynn Cain carried the ball.
He's been a great asset to this football team, especially the defense. A leader. And he knows defensive football like an assistant coach.
You think he was pleased with the move over to the strong side?
I'm sure he was. I'm sure he did a little bit of coaching on that. Suggested here and there. Second and 9.
Time call. How about Foster? Time call. Now, what happened, George? Tell me about this.
Well, I'm sure Steve saw something that was there that he didn't anticipate. He didn't want to run a play against the defense that he saw. Now he's forced to take a timeout, which I think really hurts you in your two-minute drill. You have to save all your timeouts.
I'll tell you, we never realized golf was such a tough game.
Hey, it's a lot easier hitting a quarterback than...
Now with 45% more power, the 300D sedan and the 300 CD coupe. The two newest turbo diesels from Mercedes-Benz.
At Candlestick Park in San Francisco, no score in the second quarter. Just total offense. Atlanta, 7 yards, 49 of 108.
Part of that is Atlanta was in that wet area of the field when they were trying to run the ball.
Second down and 9 for the Falcons. They have the ball at their own 14-yard line. Motion across. Screen left, taken by Andrews. Oh my. Boy. It is Ronnie Lott, the rookie from USC, and he's got the ball. That's Ronnie Lott standing down the end zone saying, look at me, but the official has marked the spot back up there at the 13.
Yeah, he blew it dead. Now, 49ers have their four defensive ends in there. Dean's putting pressure, coming in from the outside. A good hit here by Ronnie Lott. Good hard hit. Takes the ball. Jars the ball loose and picks it up and scores, but the official blew it dead. The 49ers are mixing their defense every down. Now Reynolds is out. They got the nickel defense in with four defensive ends in there.
Third and 11 at the 13-yard line. Arkowski, out to Ren King. Ronnie Lott forces him out of bounds. Got about 5 yards, but not nearly enough, and the punting unit comes off.
Well, they're dictating for the Falcon offense.
This is not the first time these two teams have played this year. They played on September 20th in Atlanta, and Atlanta won it 34-17.
Well, they're giving that defense a standing ovation.
James is back to punt. Solomon and Hicks will receive it for the 49ers. There they are, Solomon and Hicks. Some pressure, and he got it out. Solomon fair catches it, drops it, picks it up. Well, hangs on, so it'll be first and 10 at the 48-yard line.
You know, Solomon overran it. Almost fumbled the ball, almost lost it.
When play is resumed, the 49ers have it. They have it in their own territory. It's spotted now at the 49-yard line.
They say you can't slow motion, stop frame, even front load, all with Speed Search and all with Zenith's famous picture quality. Zenith. The quality goes in before the name goes on.
Deadline, Saturday, November 28th at Sears. Road Handler tires are on sale. Sears Best Steel Belted Radio. Now save $38 to $106 on a set of four. Deadline, Saturday, November 21st at Sears. The Sears 48 battery is on sale too. Next to the diehard, the best-selling replacement battery in America. Now only $49.99 with trade-in, save $10. For great automotive values, you can count on Sears.
Next weekend on CBS Sports Saturday, a battle of the undefeated. Knockout artist Aaron Pryor defends his crown against Duvon Johnson for the WBA Junior Welterweight Championship.
You heard the great hand that the defense of the 49ers got. Well, they've got a quartet back that played outstandingly well. We asked the veteran linebacker, Jack Reynolds, to tell us something about those deep backs and that deep defense.
Well, of course, they're real young yet, and I think since the last time we played Atlanta, I think it was the third game of the season, they've progressed a whole lot. But I think one of the big things that has helped them progress is that we've got a pass rush now that, you know, you don't have to cover them as long.
First and 10 at the 49. No score in the game.
Good time here to go deep, Lindsay. Got great field position.
Montana, play action. Now wants to throw back. Incomplete.
Well, that's what he had. He had Solomon deep on 37. Way downfield. And Solomon was open on Johnson, but he didn't have time to throw.
It was, he didn't have time to throw because Joel Williams was in there in his lap.
There's Solomon deep. Johnson's right with him. Here it is. Here it is again. He was going play action. He had Solomon deep, was looking for him deep.
Joel Williams, right there.
Yeah, did not have time. Williams in his face.
Second and 10 at the 49. He's lead carrying, and Buddy Curry made the stop. Gained 2 yards, 49 to 49. Third and 8. Now the first downs, Atlanta's had one, and the 49ers have had six, but there's nothing on the scoreboard.
Well, it's nice to see Jeff Merrill back in there, Lindsay. He's a tough football player, and that this defense needs him.
He's been out with a pulled hamstring. Mike Wilson comes into the ballgame. Ricky Patton comes out. That means a lone set back and three wide receivers. Wilson's far to the left side. Montana. Sack, and this time it's Joel Williams again. You know, when he was out with an injury, the Atlanta defense really missed him, and they feel his presence now that he's back.
He's a big play guy, and they're in that quagmire again. It's hard to kick from there. It's hard to center the ball, and it's hard to get a rush. Let's watch this. This is the worst part of the field right there.
Miller's in to do the punting, and Ken Johnson has dropped back to receive it. Johnson retreats to the 10-yard line. Bonds was downfield covering.
Here's a shot that could have been called for a clip. They didn't call it.
Ball is spotted at the 14-yard line. So when play is resumed, it'll be the Atlanta Falcons with the ball, but they've got it deep in their own territory at the 14.
Toyota asked to compare their new Longbed Sport truck to our Jaguar XJ6.
And we laughed.
Granted, the Toyota truck is well appointed.
I say, four-speed automatic overdrive.
Handles most nimbly.
Still, we laughed. Until Toyota told us we both had to carry a piano.
Feels like a car, works like a truck.
You know, baseball's the same in Japan as it is in America. You play 9 innings.
Hi, what is it?
3 strikes and you're out.
Out.
And after the game, there's nothing like a beer. And when Numa's in town, I treat him to light beer from Miller because it tastes great.
Cream.
Yeah, I know it's less filling, but we drink it because it tastes great.
Cream.
Listen, Numa, it tastes great.
It's your kind. Cream.
All right, it's less filling.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer. And
look at the receivers we have here in this game.
Right, we got Clark, Solomon, and I think someone's going to throw a bomb here and get a big play. That's the way this game is progressing. A play-action bomb.
First and 10 at the 14. Taking out crossing pattern. Jack Reynolds going to make the tackle on Lynn Cain.
Well, we got a report that Dean twisted his back, but they expect him to come back in and return.
O.J. Simpson. O.J. Simpson in the spectators' box here this afternoon. That's Eddie DiBartolo's box. Eddie, by the way, is observing a birthday that he had Friday. It's his 35th. Happy birthday, Eddie. Second down and 2 yards to go. Didn't get the first. He's about a yard short. I think Craig Pukki going to make the tackle.
Well, the team has already given Eddie DiBartolo his birthday present. They've won 6 straight. So that's a pretty nice present.
You know what he'd want for a birthday present.
Yeah, another one.
49ers have not lost a game since they lost on September 20th to Atlanta. It's Los Angeles. The Rams 10, New Orleans nothing. Second quarter. They're in the Western Division, keep in mind. And it is 13-13, the Bears in Kansas City in an overtime, and we know how they end.
Second overtime game of the day.
We know what ends in overtime.
You know, so far they've handled Andrews pretty good. The 49ers have handled him.
They're measuring for the possible first down, see if Andrews got it. And I guess he did. First and 10 at the 24-yard line.
Now here comes Dean back in right away.
It is Cincinnati 10, San Diego 7 in the second quarter. There is Fred Dean. First and 10 for Atlanta at their 24. No score, 7:43 left in the first half. Markowski.
Watch Dean.
A 49er is injured.
Great, great second effort. He keeps coming. Mike Ken has him out long enough, but as Bartkowski scrambles, Dean comes in from the backside right here with his quickness and gets the sack. Now somebody's down on the field. 49ers injured.
And he's getting attention from the training staff.
That's what happens when you try to scramble against a quick guy like that. Somebody can come from the backside like Dean, who has the quickness to recover, and hit you from the blind side. Looks like Pillar, is it?
Lawrence Pillars is the man injured.
Let's watch 65, see what happened to him. Pillars, now he's double-teamed. He's hit, he keeps coming. Not, oh, he got blindsided by 68.
He's up. He's up. Oh, the colors are getting off. 68 R.C. Thielman. That pillar's coming off.
Thielman. R.C. Thielman ready. Sideswiping.
Second and 14 at the 20-yard line. NFL Today report. Let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsay, just south of you in Anaheim. Here's that Ram touchdown. First touchdown pass by Dan Pastorini is a Ram, 28 yards to Preston Denard. Rams now lead the Saints by 10. Incidentally, Chicago and Kansas City are in overtime. Back to you in San Francisco.
All right, Brent, and keep in mind that these 49ers started today two games ahead of the Rams, two games ahead of Atlanta. Third down and 10 yards to go. Dickens, 50-yard line. Dickens at the 45. Keeps his consecutive game streak going.
I tell you what Bartkowski did on that play, Lindsay. He went on a quick count. Real quick count on sound. Before they were set to take off and rush. Jenkins is open. They're double-teaming the wide receivers, but he ran a crossing pattern. Got inside. Big play.
Jenkins picked up 32 yards. He now has catches in 83 straight games.
And on the previous play, Dean was on the left side, rushing from the left side.
First and 10 at the 45. Atlanta now in San Francisco territory. Kane Andrews in the setback. Play action. And gun to Kane. Well, he's kidding.
Oh, the footing is so bad at this end, Lindsay, that you can't stop or start.
He got only 3 yards on the completion. Second down and 7 yards to go. Ben Kane coming slowly back to the huddle. We have 5 minutes, 49 seconds remaining to be played in the first half at Candlestick Park in San Francisco. I'm Lindsey Nelson with George Allen, and there is no score in this ball game. Second down, 7 yards to go at the 42. Kane with room to run. He picks up the first at the 30-yard line. Carlton Williamson brought him down.
Here they are from the I formation. Kane read the blocking and watch the blocking at the point of attack. They cut back against the grain. Good block on Reynolds. Stalemate. Big hole. Kane picks up a first down. That's the first successful running play the Falcons have had today.
They are mounting their first throw of the day here. First and 10 at the 30-yard line. Bartkowski. Incomplete. R.C. Thielman getting out of the way of it out there. Fred Dean was right in his lap and finally got him down on the turf.
You know, Bartkowski has a screen pass call, but the screen man could not get out. Now he's almost sacked. Dean's right in his face. Delivery sack by Dean.
Incompletion, second and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Bartkowski quarterbacks still wearing that flak jacket.
I'm going to say both quarterbacks are wearing flak jackets here today. Bartkowski's wearing one, and so is Montana. Both have bruised ribs.
Talked about a flak jacket. It's a good thing he had a flak jacket. Watch the blow, 65 to the right, coming in. Watch him hit Bartkowski right here. Bang! And that allowed the ball to be intercepted. Throwing the ball to Jackson, 85. Nice play by Williamson.
And again, the officials are in conclave. Williamson with the interception last week against Pittsburgh. A
strong safety. He had five tackles, a fumble recovery, two passes defense, and an interception with a return of 28 yards. What a day.
But actually, what was taking place, they were blocking back. One of the rules after an interception, the closest defensive back blocks back on the intended receiver. And that's what he was doing. He was blocking back.
Salah and Martin there figuring somewhere in this play.
Pass interference. Defense, unsportsmanlike conduct, offense, extra player on the field, replay.
Oh, boy. Well, they're offsetting penalties, pass defense, and unsportsmanlike conduct.
I'll tell you, if you've ever been in doubt about a black jacket, that time, if Bartkowski didn't have that black jacket on, Lindsay, he really would have been... Here's another shot of the hit. Can you imagine the helmet right in the ribs if he didn't have that black jacket?
It is second down, 10 yards to go, and the ball's at the 30-yard line.
Great shot.
It was the 49er pass. Andrews Carrick picked up about 2 yards to the 28-yard line. Bobby Leopold made the tackle. And now, for an NFL Today report, once again, let's go to Brett Musburger in New York.
Lindsay, the Saints set up the end around. They give the ball to George Rogers, but he keeps it, and he turns the corner, and the rookie sensation is on his way. 59 yards for a touchdown. The Saints now are back in it against the Rams. I'll send it back to you in San Francisco.
All right, Brett. George Rogers turning it on and doing his thing. Third down and 8 yards to go here. Ball at the 28-yard line. Still no score. Bartkowski lost in it to Jackson. Incomplete.
I'll tell you, Lindsay, what's taking place. Bartkowski has not been able to set and throw that ball. He had to throw that off balance again. He can't set and deliver the ball accurately.
Mick Luckhurst, the field goal man, is coming on. There he is, Mick Luckhurst, the rookie from the University of California at Berkeley, just across the bay. Left footer, and James is in the hole. James is the holder.
Let's see if he's got a dry area to put the ball down.
That'll be a 46-yard attempt, and his long for the year is 47.
Watch the holder and the snap. Look.
Left footer, Mick Luckhurst.
Watch him slip. Good snap. Pretty good hole, but Luckhurst slips. Falls.
And the ball goes over at the line of scrimmage, which is the 28th first and 10 to the San Francisco 49ers.
The reason he missed it is because of the footy.
And
you know what this, Lindsay, you remember this. This reminds me of Kezar. That's the way Kezar used to be at one time.
Lehman Bennett talking to Mick Luckhurst about what just happened and what you just saw. First and 10 at the 28. Montana still has it. He's going long to Clark. Clark's got it. Bryce Clark inside the 30-yard line. Stopped by Brad Moore and Johnson.
And listen, it looks like there may have been a late hit by Jeff Merrill on Montana. Let's see it. Here's the big play we've been talking about off of play action. Now watch 75 come in. A delivery sack on Montana.
A 44-yard pickup to Dwight Clark.
Here it is. Clark going deep on a post pattern on Johnson. Wide open. Big play.
And now the additional penalty. Puts the ball at the 14-yard line.
Personal foul. I'm not sure you're up. He's going to pass for first down.
It was on Jeff Merrill. You saw it, and it's first and 10 now for the 49ers at the Atlanta 14-yard line.
Well, that was a question of whether Jeff Merrill could let up and avoid hitting Montana. That's what I refer to as a delivery sack. The quarterback's hit as he's throwing the ball. And it's a good thing he had a black jacket on also.
Schumann is coming to the ball game at a wide receiver now. Montana calls for timeout.
Well,
he's a little upset, and he calls the timeout.
Now, here's what we talked about again. Both clubs have had to use a timeout and not have them for the two-minute drill because of having a play come into the huddle too late.
Teams now, Atlanta, I look for Atlanta to come back with a big play because Atlanta's a home run hitting team. Alfred Jenkins, Jackson, one of those guys, or Junior Miller down the middle. Neither team's going to run that much with the condition of the field today.
Bill Walsh, the head coach, he's in his third year here. 49 of fever, and it's all over this town of San Francisco.
To kick off here, Lindsay, because you can't get any footing.
Wershing's looking for a place to set the tee.
Now, he's allowed to move that over to the hash mark. He doesn't have to kick it right there in the middle. He probably have to take a short run so he doesn't slip.
Scott Warner is center deep back there for Atlanta, standing on the goal line. We are approaching the automatic timeout. That's Warner that comes at the two-minute warning. Short, extremely short. He took it there. Warner takes it at the 20, 25, 30, 35, and to the 38-yard line. First and 10. He took a divot on the kickoff.
Yeah,
Eric Wright made the tackle.
He slipped and fell, and that the reason he got such a poor kickoff, he has no footing to run or plant.
There comes Bartkowski now. He has 21 touchdown passes this year. 11 of them have gone to Alfred Jenkins.
And great field position right here.
Pittsburgh 21 and Seattle 10 at halftime. The Jets 24, Baltimore 14 at halftime. Damon Andrews with a setback. Bartkowski looking to go long. Incomplete. Trying to get it to Wallace Francis. Eric Wright covering.
Well, that's just what we talked about. A play-action bomb to Wallace Francis, but Eric Wright was right with him, step for step.
Alfred Jackson, big play Jackson has come in now for Atlanta.
And
Francis has gone out.
Lindsay, one more thing. Mike Ken is doing a good job on Fred Dean. Dean is in there again at right end this play. Let's see that matchup. That's a very interesting matchup.
Ken has gone off. Three wide receivers in the ballgame now. Francis, Jackson, Jenkins.
Bartkowski's getting ready the ball a lot quicker than he would normally like to. Holding
against Atlanta.
Let's watch what happens to Dean here. Fred Dean, 74, and Mike Ken, 78. Outside rush.
Ten yards marked off to the 28-yard line.
Holding, number 67, second down.
Eric Sanders.
That's
second and 20.
is Jackson Jenkins, wide receiver. Andrews long touchdown. Now Andrews slips down at the 33-yard line.
This field, Lindsay, as I mentioned earlier, is really a disadvantage to a guy like Andrews, who has quick feet and relies on his quickness more than his speed. Now, he's got a chance to have a long gainer here. And watch, he tries to cut right here, and he slips and falls.
And third down conversions today, Atlanta is 1 for 7. This is third and 15. Still three wide receivers. Well downfield at the 35-yard line.
They're really dictating to the Atlanta offense.
Now you see it again, Dean and Board. They've got Pillars, Stuckey, Dean, and Board in there in that alignment.
Well, they get them in these long yardage situations. Markowski's at a disadvantage in these third and 15 situations.
Unsportsmanlike conduct on the dead ball, number 85.
That would be Alfred Jackson. 85 right there. Clock is stopped at 2:33 as we approach the 2-minute warning. Back to the 12-yard line. So James is back in deep punt formation to boot it out of there. He's standing in his own end zone. Solomon and Hicks have dropped back, standing at their own 45 to receive it for the 49ers. 49ers are leading the game by a score of 7-0. The San Francisco 49ers start now in Atlanta territory. First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
Well, they had a pretty good rush on that play, Lindsay. Now here's a good time to go play action and go deep. Throw it into the end zone.
Time remaining inside lower right-hand corner of your screen. 2 minutes, 22 seconds. The clock starts on the snap, and the score is the 49ers 7. And Atlanta nothing. Solomon on a pass from Montana scores the touchdown. Worthing kicks the point. That accounts for the seventh. Paul Hofer's in there. Aaron Wainwright. Montana. Clark. Nice Clark. At the 36-yard line. Eichendahl and Curry made the stop.
Well, he threw the ball. That's the thing to do. When you got good field position, the field is pretty dry right here in the middle. It's flow action week. With Clark curling over the middle, he can dump it off to the back so he can hit Clark. Clark was open.
We have reached the 2-minute warning. The automatic timeout has arrived. That comes with the 2-minute warning. Montana has walked to the sideline. Coming up at halftime today now, Brett and Irv in New York with scores and highlights from all around the league. They'll bring you up to date on everything that's happening on this big day in the NFL. Then there'll be a special feature, Football by the Bay.
You know, Lindsay, we talked a lot about Dean, but he reminds me the way he rushes a passer by one of the greatest defensive ends of all time, Doug Atkins.
Doug Atkins, who played his college football at the University of Tennessee, then came into the league with Cleveland, and then you had him with the Chicago Bears.
Tremendous football player against the run, against the pass. I was asked to pick the 100 best football players since 1933, and Atkins was the first guy I thought of. He's that type of guy. So if old Doug is listening back there in Knoxville, when he sees Dean, he's seen himself about 20 years ago.
Each team has two timeouts remaining now, and so
Walsh is there with Montana. What goes on here, George?
Well, right now, they've got two timeouts left, as you said. They're going to call two plays in the huddle. Now, they're second and two. They can run to pick up the first down, or they can throw. They want to keep this field position and come away with at least 3 points. Go into the half with at least 10 points. And so they're calling two plays in a huddle, and if they're successful, they're talking about two more plays.
Well, Corral's put in a field goal for Los Angeles. It's 13-7 on the second quarter. Keep in mind that that game affects this one. They're all Western Division teams. Hofer carries, but he didn't get it. Jeff Yates in to make the tackle. Montana, after starting this afternoon, 0 for 7 in the air, is now 9 for 21, 138 yards, one interception, one touchdown.
Now he's getting a call from the sidelines.
Third and three.
See, really, third and three is a passing situation.
Hofer's coming off, holding his left arm limp. Hofer comes off, apparently injured. Montana breaks the huddle. Clark has come off. Patton easily on the setback.
Did not get it.
It's going to be fourth down coming up. Jeff Yates in to make the tackle. Timeout taken by Atlanta. Falcons use their second. They've got one more. 1:17 on the clock.
Yeah, now the 49ers have to decide whether to kick a field goal or go for it. Looks like they're going to, or punt.
That's Hofer along the sideline. He came off holding his left arm very limp, and he's exercising it there now. Apparently, it feels a lot better than it seemed to when he came off. He's used to the bumps and bruises, Paul Hofer. Well, the punt return unit has dropped back, and Scott Werner is back there to receive it.
And Lindsay, Atlanta has to be wary of a fake punt right in here. This is a good area of the field to fake a punt and throw a pass.
Well, it only wears one shoe, wouldn't fake a punt, would he? Fourth down. There he is, the barefoot boy from Mississippi. Yeah, he kicks to the one that doesn't have the shoe on. And it is a touchback. It'll be put in play first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Tim Miller coming off. Keep in mind now that Brett Mayer will bring you up to date on all the happenings around the NFL during the halftime intermission. And then we'll be standing by here and all ready to bring you another half of exciting football. We had a battle here, mostly a defensive battle for a good part of this game. And then the 49ers scored, and they're leading it by a score of 7-0. 49ers came into the game with a record of 7 wins and 2 losses. The Atlanta Falcons came into the ballgame with a record of 5 wins and 4 losses, trailing the 49ers by 2.
Bartkowski will probably go deep somewhere in this series.
He's got Jackson and Francis double to the right side. Bartkowski goes the screen. Taken by Andrew. Stripped up by Ronnie Lott. Lost his balance. They're ready to go as soon as the ball is spotted at the inbounds marker, and it's going to be a first and 10 at the 30-yard line.
That's a good counter against that pass rush that he's facing today.
Clock is running with 45 seconds left to play in the half. Trying to get something on the board before intermission. Chicken at the 45-yard line. First and 10. Eric Wright made the stop.
And Pillars had a delivery sack on Bartkowski.
No huddle. They're ready to go. 24 seconds left in the half. Bartkowski. With someone hanging on to his leg, he puts it up, and it is intercepted by Dwight Hicks. His sixth interception of the year, and Dwight Hicks returns it to the 46. The clock is stopped with 9 seconds left to play in the half.
Bartkowski threw that ball. Somebody had him by the leg, so he threw it with somebody hanging on to him. I think Dwayne Board, 76, let's see, has him right around the leg. Yeah, right there. See that? So he can't get set and put anything on it. Throws an interception. That's the second interception he's thrown like that with somebody hanging on to him.
Number six for Dwight Hicks in the interception department this season. Clock starts again on the snap.
Here it is. Here it is again. 76, Board beating Saunders and hanging on right here. And he decides to get rid of it. Throws the interception.
9 seconds on the clock. Wilson, Wilson, a double. A wide receiver, Montana. And it's completed to Solomon. He took it up to 31. 2 seconds left on the clock. 2 seconds left on the clock. He got out of bounds to stop the clock at the 36-yard line.
They got time for a field goal.
And coming on is the field goal unit. Ray Wilson's coming out to boot it. Clock doesn't start till the snap.
That was a well-executed play. Got him out of bounds to stop the clock. The pass took him right out of bounds.
It'll be a 50-yard kick. I beg your pardon, it was a 49-yard kick. I'm kind of holding for Wilson.
The Packers hold on to beat the Giants 26-24. Dan Cinerud kicks 4 field goals for Bart Starr. Now watch Scott Bruner, intercepted earlier by Estes Hood, who went the distance.
But I tell you, your better defensive teams always have an interception return. It's like you have a punt return or a kickoff return. Watch that wall of blockers forming in the left sideline here as Estes Hood rambles up 41 yards for the touchdown.
Then the big moment for the Giants. Down by 2 touchdowns, nobody picked up Gary Shirk. Fake field goal. Bruner, who had replaced the injured Phil Sims, drilled him for the touchdown, and the Giants had climbed back in it. Then Bruner went to Mike Freedy, and Green Bay's lead was cut to 2, but again it was Cinerud. Nailing down this 24-yarder, he was 4-for-4, 301 for his career, and they win it 26-24 over the Giants. Miami in overtime over New England, 30-27. Von Schaumann with a field goal in overtime, 7:51, 30-yarder, nailed it down. One of 2 overtime games today. The wildest game of the afternoon. The Redskins at the buzzer nailed down the Lions, 33-31. It was wild right for the start, and what a day Billy Sims had. For the game, he rushed for 159 yards, scored a couple of touchdowns. Joe Washington answered with 144 yards for the Redskins. Washington led by 2 after that touchdown, and then it was Mark Mosley. 44 seconds to go. He hit the field goal. The Redskins led it. But the legend, Eric Hippel, wasn't through her.
Wasn't through yet with only 4 seconds left to go in the game, Brent. Eric Hippel goes high for the old Hail Mary pass and hits Mark Nichols. But watch what happens.
Get in. No timeouts. Couldn't stop the clock. It's over. 33-31. Now the Oilers down the Raiders. 17-16 is the count there. Minnesota over Tampa Bay. The final 25-10. And going in, Ted Brown knew just how important this game was for the Vikes.
Yes, everybody knew exactly what this game meant. It meant the lead in the division. So everybody came out and played 110% and was looking forward to playing Tampa Bay, wanted to play them. And we just wanted to prove to the people and to ourselves that we are a pretty good team.
And Ted Brown is a pretty good running back. 31 carries for 129 yards and that touchdown right there. How did Tommy Kramer do? 24 of 41 for 228 yards and this to Joe Sensor got the Vikes down to the 3 and Kramer threw his only touchdown pass of the game to Ricky Young. Doug Williams was embarrassed late in the game. A safety and Minnesota moved to first place in the NFC Central 25-10. And we just now have an overtime conclusion. The Chicago Bears have won 16-13. John Rovetto attempting the field goal. It is good. And let me tell you what happened just moments before that winning field goal, which just happened. The Bears had one blocked. But the Chiefs were called for that old illegal lift play. They boosted up a guy. They gave him another chance, drove to the five, kicked the field goal. Bears in overtime, a winner over Chiefs. Philadelphia against St. Louis this afternoon. 52-10. Ron Jaworski and Harold Carmichael and Wilbert Montgomery and all that gang, they just ate him up, Irv. And here's Montgomery.
Boy, I tell you, Montgomery is not only a great ball carrier, but he's an excellent receiver as well. Here he takes this one in early in the first quarter.
This time he wants Rodney Parker. 33 yards. Look at the time he had as that offensive line of Dick Vermeil's does a number. Oh, Big Harold, I love this pass play.
Well, anybody 6'8 can do anything he wants to. He rambles through that Cardinal secondary, picks this one off, shakes off the defender, and walks into the end zone easily.
All right, Irv, we still have a handful of games that are working right now. The Jets have exploded against Baltimore. They lead that one 24-14. How about the Steelers? Well, they're 21-10. They're over the Seahawks right now. Cincinnati doing a number on San Diego, 24-7. They're still in the second quarter. Denver has come back. Yes, Steve Watson's done it again. 12 passes caught for 12 touchdowns from Craig Morton. 10-7 is the count. And, of course, the two games that you're watching, the Rams leading the Saints 13-7. And in the one up in San Francisco, the 49ers right now are ahead of the Atlanta Falcons 10-0. And, of course, we'll have highlights of both games as the second halves unfold. And back with a look at San Francisco as the NFL Today continues on CBS after these messages from your local stations.
This team in football and the most surprising team in football. But how do their fans react to all that? Pat O'Brien reports from a city where football is as much a way of life as your blee in a hip flask.
Sometimes the football fan becomes just as an important story as the football team, especially in the way fans express themselves. Who could forget Denver a few years back when the whole town was painted orange, things plastered all over the city? And how about in Dallas, where they not only have the Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders, but fans all over that city always cheering for Dallas, America's team? And who could forget the image of fans in Pittsburgh wearing these colors on a cold Sunday afternoon? That brings us to San Francisco. They've got one of the hottest teams in the NFL right now, but this city seems to be in a state of disbelief. In fact, it might even be part of being a 49er fan. And it's been that way, really, ever since they moved to Candlestick Park. It did not used to be that way when the 49ers were playing here at Kezar Stadium in Golden Gate Park. Yes? This is where the 49er faithful met.
Running out, Tittle may go to the alley-oop this time. He's got Arcee on top, but no, he throws a pass over the left side to McElhinney. McElhinney getting near the sidelines. Let's get out around if he can't stop.
We called it 49er U. We were part of the student body. We sat there in the park and got juiced and stoned and went to the game. I was a faithful then, but as soon as they started losing, I gave up because I'm a Sunday Patriot, Sunshine Patriot, front runner. If they don't win, the heck with it. Who cares? There's something else to do. Let's go play tennis.
No time for tennis for Coach Bill Walsh. No time for anything except football.
So I just don't really have any dealing with the public other than you fellas today. I'm just too heavily involved in what I'm doing. But I assume that in this city, it's a very, very enthusiastic general population.
Well, they were heroes after defeating the Steelers. Pretty exciting at the airport. But it is 49er fan tradition to hope for the best and expect the worst.
I think it's part of the losing mentality.
Well, they've been let down so many years, I don't think they need preparation anymore.
I think they're getting excited, but I think you have a lot of, the fair-weather fans.
Were you a fan last year?
No, just until they started winning.
Oakland had its good years, and then the stadium went back up. Now Oakland's starting to lose, and you can see people dropping off.
Well, the Oakland fans are much more dedicated, devoted, and intense. Because they don't have, for instance, a major sport like opera.
Oh, yeah, I'm waiting for a Super Bowl to cross the bay.
They're killers. They're really good. I like them, too.
I was up in the mountains, up in Monte Rio over the weekend, and there was this place they were having a brunch, and half of the place was packed with all 49er fans, and it was like the other side. They were all trying to eat breakfast, and it was wild. It was unbelievable.
Yeah, sure. I like the 49ers.
We're back. Six in a row. Gotta like it.
Well, it's been a wait till next year town, meaning either the 49ers or the Giants or the earthquake. Now we're waiting for that's going to be our next major event. It's not going to be the Super Bowl. It's going to be the big one. We could go any minute, taking the 49ers with us.
Pat O'Brien, CBS Sports, San Francisco.
Well, Herb is waiting for the big earthquake. Joe Martinez is trying to light up Atlanta, right? It should be some second half. We'll have updates in both the Ram game and the Atlanta-San Francisco game as the NFL Today continues on CBS in just a moment.
football game. He did it on a pass reception from Joe Montana in the second quarter. And that is Ray Wershing, who booted the field goal in the extra point. He'll kick it off, and Scott Werner is deep to receive it for the Atlanta Falcons. This is Lindsey Nelson with George Allen and Candlestick Park in San Francisco. Werner moves over. He's got it at the six-yard line, 10, 15, 20. Werner trying to bounce off to the outside is stopped at about the 27-yard line by Bill Ring. So the Atlanta Falcons start. Here are our stats on the first half play.
Well, Lindsey, I think the big story here that these stats may or may not show is that the 49ers have been able to rush Bartkowski with four defensive ends, Dean, Stuckey, Pillars, and Board. They put pressure on him most every down. He's had to throw the football with people hanging on. And the Falcons, in this position on the field, have not been able to run. The footing on the field is such that Andrews has not been able to get the ground game going like he usually does.
First and 10 at the 28, Bartkowski skids a little as he sets up. Throws short. Short hopped it. Taken by Wallace Francis. This crowd is sky high. You see, the 49ers have never had a record of 8-2 in their entire history in the NFL. If they win today, they're 8-2.
Well, now here comes the nickel personnel and the four defensive ends I just talked about. Dean is coming in. Harper and Reese are coming out.
49ers haven't won a division since 1972. They have been coming on a roll. They came into this game with six consecutive victories, hoping for seven here, and they're leading 10-0.
Mike Ken has done a pretty good job on D.
Second down and 10 yards to go. Passes in motion across. Bartkowski. Incomplete. Francis could not hang on. Solid and Martin cover.
Well, the ball was thrown behind him, Lindsey. You'll see this. 49ers run a stunt. Dean's going to come right up the middle. C-74 running a stunt. Now, he has time, but the ball is thrown behind him. You see that? Behind him and low. Now, Bartkowski is throwing on a soft turf here. He can't set up like he wants to. You watch him go back to pass. He's worried about slipping.
Third and 10, three wide receivers, Dickens, Jackson, Francis. Kenny has gone out. Bartkowski skids, throws it behind Andrews.
All three times he tried to throw, the condition of the turf bothered him. He's worried about slipping and falling.
There have been earlier complaints this year that the surface was too hard at Candlestick. It's not too hard today.
No, watch him right here. He's setting up with unsure footing. See, he threw all with his arm there.
John James is back to do the punting. Long high spiraling kick. Hicks is waiting. He's got it at the 25. Right here. At the 30, 35, and up through the 38-yard line. It was James Mayberry downfield to make the tackle. And so when play is resumed, it'll be the 49ers in possession. They'll have it first and 10 at the 39-yard line. A little help with the equipment there, getting the holster tightened up a little bit. Apparently he's all right and no particular pain. It is first and 10 to 39 now. 49 to lead 10-0. And it's Bobby Butler on the corner who made the hit.
Well,
that's a 41.
Jeff Yates made a heck of a play on that.
And the Chicago Bears have defeated Kansas City 16-13 in overtime. Rivetto kicked a 22-yard field goal. It's the second game he's won in overtime with a field goal. And Cincinnati is leading San Diego 31-10. That's at halftime.
Well, that won't hurt Kansas City or Oakland.
Second down and 8 yards to go. At the 41. Joe Montana. Forced him out.
Well, you see, Montana can do that in this area of the field. It's good and dry, and he's agile enough and quick enough, and this is one of the pluses for the 49ers to have a quarterback like this that can get out of trouble and not take a big loss and come up second and 16. Got out of bounds.
Got out at the line of scrimmage. No loss. Third and eight at the 41.
Now, usually in this third and eight, there the Jets leading Baltimore, 31 to 14. What Montana likes here is just to get the first down. On the stop pattern, have the receiver go about 8-9 yards and get the first down.
Montana, the part. Well, it's a completed pass for about 2 yards. Bob Glazebrook led the stop.
Well, they flushed him out of the pocket. He didn't want to throw that. He was running away from the rush, dumped it off to Clark.
Montana coming off from Monongahela, Pennsylvania. Back to do the punting now is Jim Miller. And Warner is dropping back to receive it. Got Warner at the 15-yard line. Warner at the 18-yard line at the 20 to 25, and he stopped right there at the 25-yard line. Now Randy Cross. The play is resumed. It'll be first down and 10 yards to go. And the Atlanta Falcons will have the ball at their own 25-yard line.
Stat, average yards on first down is unlike Atlanta, 2.5, 49ers 7.6.
See what they do on this first down at their own 25. Bring it on the ground. Andrews to the 29-yard line before Willie Harper made the stop. Picked up 4, 2nd and 6.
Well, they're in the soft part of the field again, Lindsay. It's tough to get a takeoff and cut here.
Andrews has carried 9 times for 32 yards.
Atlanta doesn't have that balanced offense today that they usually have, run and pass.
Three wide receivers in there just now, and only Andrews is a setback, and that's he right there.
What they need is a big play. A home run.
Andrews. Nothing. Willie Harper closed him down along with Archie Reese. No gain. 3rd and 6.
Now here comes the pass rushers. Board, Dwayne Board, Fred Dean, 76 and 74.
Archie Reese comes off.
Here comes Martin, 29.
Reynolds comes off. Pookie comes off. Third down play. 3rd and 6. Unloads it complete for the first down. Taken by Jackson. And Williamson made the stop. 1st and 10.
Well, Lindsay, that's what he has to do. A quick pass, a slant in pass. 1, 2, 3. Fire the ball. Over the middle, even with that good pass rush, he can get rid of the ball. That's what he has to do to counter that rush. Quick passes.
Fred Dean comes off. Reynolds is back. There he is. Hacksaw. Ben Kane is in that backfield with Andrews now. The double receivers to the left side. 1st and 10 at the 39. But he is swarmed as he got to the 42-yard line. Jack Reynolds leading the defensive charge.
You know, Andrews is a quick starter. He comes out of the blocks like he's running 100. He can't start quickly on this field. No way he can start quickly. He's feeling his way.
Information being replayed out into the huddle. It's at the 42-yard line. 2nd and 7. William Andrews. Junior Miller's in a wide left.
Here's the last play you just saw. Andrews blocking Harper. Harper playing it perfect. Andrews slipped. He shot too soon. He went to the ground. The better back you are, Lindsay, the more this field affects you. This field would affect a guy like Walter Payton, Tony Dorsett, that type of back.
3rd and 9 at the 40-yard line. Big play.
the same type of play I just talked about. And he was rushed by Pillars. Pillars is having a big game, 65. It's a slant pass, allows him to get rid of the ball in the third step. Second first down in a row they've made with that type of a pass. Let's watch Pillars again, 65. Delivery sack. Pillars is having a big game.
First and 10 at the 44-yard line of San Francisco. Andrews slipped on the cut.
Well, that's just what I've been saying the whole ball game.
Andrews?
You can't cut on this field. And this is the good part of the field.
Loss of a yard on the play makes it second and 11.
Yeah. Watch him go wide and try to cut back. He slipped with his left foot going out from underneath it.
Red Dean is back in here now. Three wide receivers in for Atlanta. Jackson, incomplete. Solid and Martin covering.
Well, Bartkowski has the right counter for this pass rush. Quick passes, slant in passes, and that's what he had, but he threw it too high.
Third down, 11 yards to go at the 45.
Bartkowski, Lindsay, is 11 for 23, one interception, and only 107 yards.
8 minutes, 12 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Jackson's going wide to the right side. They're doubling Francis. And Jenkins to the left side. He's got it. He got the first and 10 at the 33-yard line. Skidding out, Eric Wright there covering on the corner.
Well, same type of action, a quick pass, throwing it out. Ball's a little bit underthrown. Receiver slips and falls down, but Jenkins picks up the first down right beyond the yard marker.
Ball is taken to the inbounds marker, spotted at the 33, first and 10. Atlanta moving. 49 is the leading by a score of 10-0 in the third quarter. Three wide receivers in there for the Atlanta Falcons. Covered on the snap. Bartkowski pulled out, didn't have the ball, and he fell on it. So they retained possession.
Well, Van Noten and Bartkowski worked together on the snap.
Dwayne Board is down. That's Dwayne Board. He's getting help from the training staff. Loss of a yard on the last play.
Bartkowski tried to pull away before the ball was delivered.
So when play is resumed, it'll be second and 11 at the 34-yard line. Injury timeout. Arm or wrist. And Kugler is in there now defensively, number 77 for the 49ers. It's going to be second down, 11 yards to go for Atlanta. They held the ball at the San Francisco 34. Three wide receivers, Francis, Jackson, Jenkins. Lone setback. Lone setback is Andrews, and he's got a first down inside the 20-yard line, stopped by Dwight Hicks.
Well, that's the Andrews I'm used to seeing, Lindsay. Now, this is the good area of the field. Watch him veer and then cut back. Good blocking at the point of attack.
Andrews picked up 14 yards. He has a first and 10 at the 20-yard line of San Francisco.
See, the 49ers were playing pass, and the Falcons ran the ball.
Dean and company have come up. Keep it on the ground and get six to the 14-yard line. Keena Turner made the stop.
Well, they have one remaining back, and that's Andrews. And he's going straight ahead. Nothing fancy, just straight man-for-man blocking.
49 is second down. 4 yards to go. At the 14-yard line of San Francisco. Still three wide receivers and Andrews for Bartkowski. His body out to Juan Reynolds and Reese were there.
Well, here's Jack Reynolds, 64. Watch him fill the hole. Good body lean. Makes the makes the play with three or four others.
49ers think that on the basis of what they've seen this year, that Jack Reynolds is one of the smartest linebackers they've come across. He's been a big addition to their defense.
He is. I drafted Jack in the first round in 1970, told him he ought to buy a projector, and he invested $300. He's still using it.
Third and three. Markowski. Jenkins at the five. Now for Jenkins, Eric Wright covering.
Oh, a heck of a catch.
Wasn't that a great catch? First and goal at the five.
And Keena Turner was right in on him. Here it is. Watch Keena Turner dog. The left of the screen come right in there. Good concentration by Alfred Jenkins.
Jenkins says he figures he's about big enough at 5'9 and 152 pounds. First and goal at the five, alone set back. Passes in the slot left. Jenkins wide left. Andrews got to about the three before it was pushed back by Archie Reese.
You see the difference in Andrews starting down here. The field is dry and firm down here. Andrews took off like you're used to seeing.
It's going to be second down and goal to go, and it's going to be marked at about the three-yard line. Atlanta trying to get on the scoreboard with the 49ers leading 10-0, 4 minutes, 40 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Wayne Board has a strained shoulder. He may be back. That's the report. Is incomplete. Penalty marker covering with Randy Lott, or rather Ronnie Lott, on Alfred Jackson.
Well,
could have been pass interference in the end zone, in which case it was first and goal at the five. At the one, I beg your pardon.
Pass interference on number 42. The ball is on the 1 yard line. First down.
First down and goal to go at the one. Pass interference in the end zone by Lott.
Well, here it is. It looked like Lott jammed him when the ball was in the air.
Now Kane has come in there. They even up with Andrews. Two setbacks as they try to jam it in. And on the wing left, Mayberry. They got a touchdown. Touchdown for Atlanta.
Here it is.
Andrews took it in.
A slant to the left. Give the ball to your best back, Kane or Mayberry. The other back leads the play. It's a good sound play.
Andrews took it in. Conversion attempt coming. Luckhurst will attempt it with James holding. Luckhurst with the conversion. It's good. And so now, you see Luckhurst leaving the field. And with 4 minutes, 20 seconds left to play in the third quarter, it's now San Francisco 10 and Atlanta 7. Luckhurst has teed the ball up, and he has teed it up actually at the 34-yard line because that's the best spot he could find, I suppose.
Right. They had about 15 guys out there as a groundskeeper.
That's Ring and Hicks back to receive it, standing on the goal line for San Francisco. As we've tightened this one up here late in the third quarter, 10-7, San Francisco leading.
This is difficult for Luckhurst to kick off now. He has no footing at all.
On the kickoff return. Now here's the score. Cincinnati 31, San Diego 10 in the fourth quarter.
That division's wide open. There's nobody playing consistent football in that division anymore.
Now the NFL today will have a profile on Forrest Gregg, and it'll be next week, Los Angeles at Cincinnati, on many of these same stations.
I once offered Forrest Gregg a job as assistant coach when I was in Washington.
done a great job. Anderson at quarterback has had a great year, and he's had Cincinnati up there on top in that central division of the AFC. Others of you will see Dallas at Detroit. So check your local listings for game and time in your area. It was Danny Bonds who was shaken up and is being assisted off the field.
Well, he was hurt before this game started, Lindsay. You remember that? We got a report that he might not play today. I think he hurt his neck in the Pittsburgh game. And look, he's coming off with his, looks like it's his neck or his shoulder.
He had been a regular linebacker, called defensive signals, as
right.
A matter of fact.
This is the first game he's really missed that is playing regular.
When play is resumed now, the 49ers have it first and 10 at their 33-yard line.
I like the way Bill Ring returned that kick. Straight ahead, nothing fancy.
Easily in pattern of the setback. Montana. And Solomon, incomplete. Butler covering on the corner, second and 10.
Well, Montana had him open. He just underthrew him, that's all. He was wide open.
Joe Montana looking to get his next play. They're all called for him. Benjamin wigwags them in. There's Benjamin, who's the backup quarterback as well. Question has come up, what happens if Montana gets hurt and Benjamin has to play? Does he then wigwag his own play? Second and 10 at the 33.
Well, they probably use a messenger system in.
One or two and just got underway again to the 39-yard line before he was brought down by Johnson.
Yeah, easily slipped as he took the handoff, almost fell down, kept his balance, and showed good drive there.
Paul Hofer's coming in. It's Denver 13, Cleveland 7 in the third quarter.
That's a big game for Denver. Now, if they can win with Oakland losing, and looks like San Diego might lose, and Kansas City lost.
The Jets 38, Baltimore 14 in the fourth quarter. Hofer's in the right set, 36. Solomon in motion across. Montana. Hofer. Oh, I beg your pardon, Clark. At the 45, but there's a marker back. There's a marker back upfield. Dagendahl made the stop. Dwight Clark, the receiver.
That's usually a holding penalty, Lindsay.
Report on Bunz is a hyperextended elbow, and it is doubtful that he will return today. There's Bunz sitting there.
And he's wearing a collar.
Betty Wyatt, the referee.
Holding number 61.
Dan Audick.
By the way, Dan Audick was a good trade for this ball club. He's doing a fine job for him. At left tackle. Got him from the San Diego Chargers.
Third and 14. Montana waiting for the snap. Motion across to Colfer. Unloads to Easley. And gets out to the 32-yard line. But Kakendall makes the stop. And now for an NFL Today report, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsay, moments ago in Anaheim, the New Orleans Saints on the move. They went to the big man, George Rogers, and he powered in for his second score, and now they lead the Rams 14-13. Back to you quickly in San Francisco.
All right, Brett, in punt formation now. It'll be Jim Miller putting it up, and Ken Johnson has dropped back, standing at the 30-yard line to receive it for the Atlanta Falcons. 2:38 remaining in the third quarter.
Offside, Jeff. It's offside, Jeff.
Johnson moving over. No return. He spotted up there about the 31-2 or somewhere along there. So when play is resumed, the Atlanta Falcons get the ball, but they get it in their own territory at about the 30-yard line. 37-yard punt. The Atlanta Falcons have the football now. They're trailing about 3 points in this ball game. Bartkowski has, of course, quarterback them throughout. There go Jackson and Jenkins, double to the right side. Andrews and King are set back. Motion across Jackson. Andrews got across the 35-yard line. Picked up about three. Second down and 7 yards to go. Bobby Leopold on the tackle. Lehman Bennett, head coach of the Atlanta Falcons. Pittsburgh 21, Seattle 17, and Franco Harris, one of the 10,000 yards, the third man. O.J. Simpson and Jim Brown were the others to do that, and New Orleans 14, Los Angeles 13 now in the third quarter. Cleveland 14, Denver 13, also in the third quarter. Things are tightening up. They tightened up here, 10-7. 49ers are leading. This is Lane Kane. Penalty marker at the line of scrimmage. He got about a yard. Stopped by Jack Reynolds. We have 1 minute 46 seconds remaining to be played in the third quarter.
Encroachment.
There's a penalty marker to be checked out. You see Reynolds, the center of your picture, working with the chin strap.
Well, Lindsay, what happened? Kane slipped as he tried to cut.
Encroachment, number 79.
Encroachment, Jim Stuckey.
You know what the Oakland A's did with Wally Haas and Billy Martin to this area and the community? This is what the 49ers have done, Lindsay. You know this area, what it means to have a winner.
Well, they really have. There's lots of 49er fever around this town these days. Second down and 2 yards to go. Andrews looking for two. Penalty markers thrown into the stock by the umpire, Tom Hensley. Jack Reynolds made the stop. Archie Reese also on the tackle. Penalty against the Atlanta Falcons. So it gets the crowd reaction here at Candlestick Park.
Well, what the Falcons are doing, they're running Andrews straight ahead where you don't have to cut.
Holding, number 57.
Dan Buns, according to that number.
Not
sure about that.
They're referring to Van Note, Jeff Van
Note.
Exactly,
Van Note. Second and 12. Dropped the snap. Van Note got on it, I think. Atlanta retains possession. Jeff Van Note.
Van Note reminds me, here it is. Yeah, he never has the ball, hits his foot, and Van Note alertly recovers it. Van Note reminds me of a player I had, Lenny Hoss and Larry Morris down there in Atlanta. And Van Note must be happy because Kentucky got back in the win column.
That's pretty good. Third down at 12 yards to go at the 30. Jenkins, right, Jackson left. Big play here for the Atlanta Falcons. Third down. Incomplete. Trying to get it to Jenkins. That is Jenkins.
He's trying to split the defense. They have him covered short and long. It takes a perfect pass to get in there. He overthrew him.
John James is in to do the punting. Hicks and Solomon have dropped back to field it for the 49ers. James gets it away. Long, high, spiraling kick. Fair catch signal by Hicks. And he takes it at the 23-yard line. Clock says 48 seconds remain to be played in the third quarter. 49ers are still leading at 10-7. Hicks called for the fair catch. That's Hicks coming slowly off the field. 49ers convening their huddle.
The groundskeeper's replacing the turf, Lindsay.
What happens if a man running a long pass route collides with the turf keeper down here?
Have to put in a new rule.
First and 10 at the 23. There it is. Seattle 24, Pittsburgh 21 in the fourth quarter. By the reverse to Clark.
Buddy Curry put the wood to him on that one. That's a good play because the Falcon linebackers are so quick and they pursue so well. You need a counter play to keep them at home. So you run a reverse. Watch Buddy Curry, number 50, come over here and put the wood to him. Right here.
Clock is running. 15 seconds left to play in the third quarter.
Listen to these fans, Lindsay. Must be like Notre Dame.
Just about. They're going to let the clock run out. They're not snapping the ball. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and there it is. That's the end of the third quarter with the score, San Francisco 10, Atlanta 7. We'll be back with the start of the fourth quarter after this word from your local station.
Next weekend. CBS Sports coverage of the National...
We start the fourth quarter here at Candlestick Park. Now, this is Lindsey Nelson with George Allen. And the 49ers have the ball second, a long yard, about a yard and a half, at their own 32-yard line. Joe Montana brings them up. Patton and Easley are the setbacks. Now, the reverse to Solomon. Freddie Solomon. That's some traffic over there. Richardson made the stop.
Yeah, you only have a couple of yards to go. That's kind of a gamble in this soggy area of the field to use this. Now, Solomon, with his ability, looked like he was going to throw the football. Nobody's open, so now with his ability, he prevented losing 5 yards and maybe picked up a half a yard.
That's just what he picked up. It is now third down, 1 yard to go at the 33.
You got
to
get the first down.
Easley and Patton are the setbacks. They need a yard. Montana completes it to the tight end. Charlie Young, first catch of the day, and it's the first and 10. And now for an NFL Today report, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsey, the Rams are now looking for Rodgers. So this time, the Saints handed the ball to Wayne Wilson. And watch him dance and dart and scamper and break tackles and bust his way into the end zone. But the Saints were holding. It was called back. Let's go back to you in San Francisco.
Oh, my. And what a battle that is in the Western Division of the NFC. First down and 10 yards to go at 37. Montana drops, shovels it. There is a penalty marker on the play.
Well,
Blaisbrook got on the ball.
The clock's still running. You know, when you're holding in a running play like that shot we just saw in L.A., it has to be a takedown because you don't have to hold on a running play the way the rules are. It has to be an actual takedown to get called for holding in a running play.
49ers retain possession, and they keep it at the 35-yard line. Second down. There's Easley. Back to 34. Eichendahl and Curry.
Well, the Falcon defense is kind of taken over here this quarter, Lindsey, and this second half.
Mara goes off, Amwina comes back in.
Now here's a big play for both sides. Big plays. About third and four.
Well, it would be, except for that last loss. It's third and 14.
Third and 14.
Right.
Third and 14.
They're doubling receivers to the left side.
Solomon, here he is, driving him off. Now, Bobby Butler, you probably can't see him, slipped and fell.
Solomon was pretty much on the way to falling himself when he made the catch.
Yeah, you could, that last shot, you could see Butler on the ground.
Solomon coming off. It's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. 49ers leading in the ball game. Score of 10 to 7, and we're in the fourth quarter. Patton and Easley are the setback. Montana.
Right cut at the 20-yard line. Stopped by Johnson, Timmy Johnson. And it's a hang on to it.
Well, great play action. Clark releases inside of Johnson. Perfect pass.
right on the fingertips. Gee.
Well, this 49er crowd is alive with San Francisco first and 10 at the Atlanta 20-yard line.
Yeah, seven catches for 128 yards.
Right Carr coming out to a wide left. Young, Ricky Patton at the 16-yard line. Gain four. It'll be second and six. Kuykendall made the stop.
Well, Montana's mixing his calls pretty well. They throw on first down. Now they run on first down. Now they're second and seven.
Turnstile count today is 59,127, the fifth largest football crowd ever at Candlestick. Going to be a halfback pass. Will he fake the pass? Ricky Patton at the 11-yard line. Joel Williams made the stop.
That's a good area of the field. That's a good call by Bill Walsh. You run a halfback option right in this area of the field. It's a very good call. You can get a touchdown out of it. You get the right thing. He kept the ball.
Ethan Rampson is taken in the next play. It's going to be a double tight end alignment. Clark has come off. It's third down and a yard to go at the 11. Patton and Easley. Patton's got a first and goal at the 4 yards.
Straight ahead, gave the ball to Patton. It's what we call a switch block. Guard pulls through and blocks the linebacker. Patton protected the ball.
Not only are they moving the ball, they're using up the clock. 8.5 minutes left to play in this game. First down and goal to go at the 4 yard line for San Francisco. Still double tight end alignment. In motion. Montana throwing into the end zone. Ethan Rampson, Richardson covering defensively.
Well, that's a pretty good call in here. Would take a great catch because Montana overthrew him, and somebody was in Montana's face. Somebody forced Montana to go deep. Let's see if we can see that is. Someone coming right up here. Bobby Butler, I guess. 23.
Second down and goal to go at the 4. Ricky Patton comes off. Easley and Bill Ring are the setbacks now. Bill Ring is in there to setback. Easley to the 3 yard line. Paul Moena came in to make the tackles. Third down and goal at the 3.
Oh, what a big series this is. Pitch to Easley.
Clark's coming back in.
Omana made the play.
Lehman Bennett.
Now
facing head coach.
Yeah. This is a big game. This is a big call. The game could rest on this play right here.
Third and goal at the 3 yard line. 7 minutes, 37 seconds left. Montana. End zone.
Again. Now watch how deep the defense forces Montana. He has to throw it on the run, and Charlie Young went up, took it at his highest point. Here it is again.
Ray Wershing to attempt. Montana holding down, up and good. Look again now at the reaction from Montana on that play. Montana says touchdown, 17-7. Cushing will kick it off if he can find a place for the tee, the kicking tee there in that loose turf. Charlie Young, number 86, with Dwight Clark on the sideline, talking it over.
Well, that's a great thing for Charlie Young because he sat on the bench in L.A. for 3 years, got a chance to play regularly. He's having a great year. That drive took 8 minutes and 17 seconds, Lindsey.
And the man deep is Supernat. Reggie Smith, 5 feet 4 inches tall, making his first appearance of the day. Supernat is deep. A 10-point lead now for the 49ers with 7 minutes 29 seconds remaining to be played in this game. 49ers came in having won 6 in a row with a record of 7 wins and 2 losses, leading Atlanta by 2 games and also leading Los Angeles by 2 games in the Western Division of the NFC. Is off and tries the left side. Finally goes out of bounds, run out by Mike Wilson.
Supernat showed his quickness and his balance there, Lindsey.
Next weekend, CBS Sports Saturday brings you more great championship boxing as knockout artist Aaron Pryor defends his WBA junior welterweight crown. He has had 20 straight wins. Both of these contestants are undefeated, and it'll be DeJuan Johnson. Be ringside for all the action next week at 4:30, 3:30 Central and Pacific on CBS Sports Saturday. Juan Johnson from Hearns Stable in Detroit. Three wide receivers in the ballgame. Now the reverse play to Jackson. Big play, Jackson. Has to come inside. But hanging on is Keenan Turner.
Well, that reverse didn't fool everybody. Everybody stayed at home. Nobody was fooled. We got a report that Bunce won't return. He's out for the afternoon.
Second down and 5 to go at the 43 now for the Atlanta Falcons.
Bartkowski needs a home run. 6:47 to play.
Falcons know that if they lose this game, they will be 3 back of San Francisco with only 6 to play. Bartkowski. And it's completed. Taken by Len Kane at the 50-yard line. First.
Well, Bartkowski's taking what the defense has given him. The corners are playing deep. 49ers are playing deep. They don't want that home run. They want to make them drive and keep that clock going. Make them earn it.
So 6 minutes 16 and rolling.
Yeah, they're laying off. Here comes.
In the fourth quarter, it is Denver 20 and Cleveland 14.
Fred Dean's back in the game.
There he is, 74.
On the left side, left end.
Three wide receivers. Bartkowski. Looking right on the sideline. Across the sideline. Incomplete. Jackson, the receiver. Harper, the defender. Incomplete.
Here it is. Bartkowski had pretty good protection. Throws the ball a little high. Took him out. Took him out of bounds.
Jackson coming back.
You know, Lindsey, he feels Dean, even though he has the time. He knows, he senses where Dean is.
Second down, 10 yards to go with that ball at the 50-yard line. Still three wide receivers in there for the Atlanta Falcons. Bartkowski. Going on to Jenkins, incomplete. Donovan Martin covering.
Jenkins had Martin beaten. He just overthrew him, that's all. Jenkins was wide open, and he had time to throw. That was 6 points, Lindsey.
Third and 10 at the 50-yard line. Clock is stopped with 5:47 remaining to be played.
Now, in this situation, I think you got to get the first down. You got to pick up the first down to give you a chance to have 3 or 4 more downs, not go for the home run.
Third and 10. Jackson in motion back to the inside. To Jackson and deflected interception. Donovan Martin. Donovan Martin. He's returned it to the 26-yard line. Thielman made the stop. Penalty marker. Penalty marker back upfield. A penalty marker. Donovan Martin there. But there is a marker. Being reported to the referee. seems to be saying bring it back.
I think Ronnie Lott was just thrown out of the game. Ronnie Lott was just kicked out of the game.
Unsportsmanlike, personal foul, number 42, out of the game.
Ronnie Lott has been ejected. The rookie cornerback from USC has been ejected from the ballgame. San Francisco.
That's
the ball.
What a blow that is. You've intercepted the pass, and you have great field position. Now you lose your top defensive back.
San Francisco maintains possession. First and 10 at the 28-yard line.
Let's see if we can see it. On the right-hand part of the screen,
right there at the bottom of your screen.
There it is.
Gonna spin it.
Yeah. Elbow in the jaw.
And now the referee has reported the walk.
There it is again.
Look at the 42.
Yeah, 42 right there. Oh.
Swung the elbow.
Yeah. Swung the elbow right in the jaw. Oh, that's a good call by the official.
There is Lott. He's out of the ball game when players resume. It'll be first and 10 at the 28 with 5:39 left to play. State Park in San Francisco. This is Lindsey Nelson with George Allen, and the San Francisco 49ers have the ball first and 10 at their own 28.
A lot of pressure on that guy right there.
Lehman Bennett, head coach of the Atlanta Falcons. Leave it on the ground to Easley, and he's out across the 30-yard line before Kuykendall brings him down for a gain of 2 at second and 8.
Now, here's where you have to be able to run the ball. You're ahead. You have enough points. You got to keep that clock going. You have to be able to run and pick up a few first downs.
You like Montana, don't you?
Oh, I like him from the beginning. When they were losing, you remember, Lindsey, I said, I like this guy. He's going to develop into a good quarterback, you see. Shows a lot of poise, Lindsey.
Made a difference when they gave him the job and traded DeBerg, didn't it?
Right.
He didn't have to compete.
That's exactly right.
Eddie Solomon is in there at quarterback, and that's Solomon with the ball. Solomon took the handoff. He took the snap at quarterback and has returned it up there to the 38-yard line. Eddie Solomon took the snap. He was a quarterback in college.
Right. Surprise play. That's the way to catch it, Lindsey. There he is. When he's in there, he's going to run with the ball.
Montana coming back out.
Trying to get a big play out of a gadget play. Good thinking, but it didn't fool the...
Apparently another marker, and now the officials are in conclave again.
Didn't fool the Falcons. The other thing, you have to be ready for Solomon for is throwing a pass. Line him up as a receiver and have him come back and throw a forward pass.
The officials have had a great deal of talking to each other here this afternoon. It's been that kind of a ball game. Freddie White will pace it off, and it's against Atlanta. The Piggy to the 47-yard line.
Personal foul, late hit, 56, first down.
A late hit puts it first and 10 at the 47 of Atlanta and 49 at possession. 4:57, time remaining inside lower right-hand corner of your screen. Well, easily dropped the ball, but he fell on it.
Yeah.
Easily dropped the ball and fell on it. And so now, for an NFL Today report, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York. We had a short trip, and it is now second and 10 at the 47-yard line.
49ers have had two big breaks here. This last one, easily recovering the fumble. He never had the ball. Fumble on the exchange.
And easily are the setbacks for the 49ers, who have a 10-point lead in this ball game, 17-7. It's easily. Pass to the 46 before Kuykendall comes in to make the tackle. Due to the length of today's football game, 60 minutes will be seen in its entirety following football, except on the West Coast, where it'll be seen at its regular time.
Well, Lindsay, that clock is still moving. 3:47.
Third down and 9 to go at the 46. Here's a final. Seattle beat the Pittsburgh Steelers. Final score 24-21.
Boy, what a tough loss that is for the Steelers. Theotis Brown scored the winning touchdown.
Third and 9. Leave it on the ground again. Taken by Easley, and Laughlin came in to make the tackle. So now, for an NFL Today report, let's go to Brent Musburger in New York.
Lindsay, the Saints are marching against the Rams. Here comes Wayne Wilson again. He winds his way 16 yards for a score. Would you believe it? Called back again. The Saints have had three touchdowns called back because of penalties. Back to you in San Francisco.
Would you believe that?
The Rams are living right, Lindsay.
Aren't they, though? There's a 4th and 7 coming up at the 44.
Well, they have to punt the ball.
Clock says 2:42, and they're going to take a delay.
Right, they're going to.
They'll take a delay.
Take as much of the time as they can.
Delay of game. 5 doesn't hurt them at all in the punting situation. As we approach the automatic timeout at the 2-minute warning.
Did Brent say that was the third touchdown callback?
I think he did.
I've never seen it. I've seen two. I had a game once.
Delay, fourth down.
Where we had two touchdowns called back, but never three.
Really, that is something.
Let's see if they try to block this kick.
You saw Montana on the phone, on the sideline. Jim Miller's in to do the punting. Scott Warner is dropped back there deep to receive it. He's standing at the 10-yard line. I don't want that football.
Well,
penalty mark at the line of scrimmage. Fair catch signal goes up. At the 10-yard line, Warner makes the catch.
And the penalty is on the 49ers. Offensive lineman was moving, leaning.
Motion.
You got it exactly.
Catch it. Take it back.
That's a 5-yarder.
I'd make him kick over.
I would think so, because the fair catch was made at the 10-yard line.
Well, go for another block.
2:32 on the clock.
Illegal motion, number 21, fourth down.
Miller back in deep punt formation again.
Now he's kicking out of the mud, Lindsay.
Now they get Warner off the field, and they get Ken Johnson in there to receive this kick. Yeah. I beg your pardon, Supernat, Reggie Smith it is. Reggie Smith is back there deep. Supernat moves up. He takes it at the 16. Here the 20. Up, ended by the kick coverage. Randy Cross. So it is first down and 10 yards to go for the Atlanta Falcons. They have the ball just across their own 20 at about the 23-yard line. 2:23 to play. 50 minutes, and then Archie Bunkus plays One Day at a Time. Alice, the Jeffersons, and Trapper John M.D. all tonight on CBS.
Lindsay, just to show you the job the 49ers have done on defense, Atlanta has only made 76 yards running.
They have it first and 10, just short of their own 24-yard line. Three wide receivers in the ball game. Markowski. Andrews. Goes out of bounds at the 33-yard line. Run out by Keena Turner. Second down, about a yard to go. Stop the clock with 2:16. Time remaining inside lower right-hand corner of your screen. kick is Jackson. Wallace Francis to the wide receiver. Orchowski. Screen left to Andrews. Oh, boy.
You know,
Gina Turner. Gina Turner impeded him.
I like Gina Turner. He's physical. He's quick. Pillars put such a rush on Bartkowski that he could barely get the screen off.
It is a first down.
Now watch this. What's 65 Pillars? Watch him throw the blocker. How? Good rush. Boy, they put pressure on Steve today.
Timeout taken here now by the Falcons. And it is stopped with 2:07 remaining. Bartkowski talking to Lehman Bennett.
Yeah, they can't run much. They got to put the ball in the air. A lot can happen in two minutes and 7 seconds.
So when play is resumed, the ball is at the 35-yard line, first and 10 with 2:07. 2:07 remaining now. First and 10 at the 35-yard line for the Atlanta Falcons. Bartkowski has the snap. And it is incomplete to Alfred Jenkins.
Well, Alfred jumped. Watch Alfred jump for the ball. He doesn't have to jump for it. And he misses it. Ball's not that high. It goes right through his hands. Lindsey, does that bring a few memories coming back here to San Francisco?
It really does. And here at Candlestick Park, of course, it's high jubilation of Big God, and the 49ers have had a big day. Listen to the crowd here now. As they look at that, with 3 minutes left, the Saints 21, the Rams 13, and of course they tied in with the fortune of the Rams in the Western Division.
And George Rogers has scored 3 touchdowns.
Completed, taken by Junior Miller, and he gets it up to the 48-yard line. If the Saints win that ball game, and if the 49ers win this one, then the 49ers will be leading both Los Angeles and the Falcons by 3 games with 6 to play. Good spot. Timeout taken.
Touchdown that Lindsey Nelson just told you about. George Rogers on the day. 24 carries, 161 yards, and 3 touchdowns. And the Saints in their history have never swept any team, and now they're closing in. Back to Lindsey Nelson and George Allen in San Francisco.
And here, San Francisco 17, Atlanta 7. When play is resumed, it'll be at the 48-yard line, first and 10 for Atlanta. 1 minute, 55 seconds left to play in the game here.
They have to score, Lindsey, on this series, whether it's a touchdown or a field goal. They have to get some points this series to get back in the game.
The wide receivers for Bartkowski. Andrews, the lone setback. Bartkowski. Chickens trying to keep his feet in, and he did. He did. He made it at the 25.
What?
He did a limbo step.
Yeah, great catch by Chickens. He's going down. Watch him. He's going down. The ball's throwing outside. He keeps both feet in. He's on his knees. Makes a catch. Legal catch. Great play by Jenkins.
Ben Thomas covering on that corner. It's going to be first and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Here's another view of it. It also stops the clock. He's going down to the ground. He goes down to both knees and stays in. That's perfectly legal.
Bartkowski brings him up first and 10. Andrews guarding the defense of the 49ers. Going long to the end zone to Jackson. He's got it. Touchdown. Big play, Jackson.
Well, they did, Lindsey, exactly what I said they had to do. Now, Jackson, if we see that again, had his eye on the ball all the way. He knew he was going to catch that. It's an up pattern, a go pattern to Jackson. He's got his eye on the ball all the way. Watch him. He sees that ball all the way. Perfect throw.
Saladin Martin covering defensively. Conversion attempt coming now. 1:43 on the clock.
Martin's backwards turn. Didn't see it. Jackson saw it all the way.
Mick Luckhurst will kick. James will hold. Luckhurst is left-footed. It's good. So with 1 minute 43 seconds left to play in the game, we've closed to 3 points once again. 49ers 17, the Falcons 14. Look again now at the touchdown.
Here's another angle on the touchdown. It's a go pattern. We said they had to have a big play to get back in. He's watching Jackson all the way. Jackson sees the ball all the way. He's under control, right in the fingertips. Martin did not see the ball.
George, I always figured from a coach's point of view, 143 can be an awful lot of time.
You know the tough decision right now that Bennett has to make, and I've had to make it many a time.
Onside kick?
Do you go for an onside kick, or do you kick it all the way down there?
Try to get it back.
And try to get it back.
All right.
That's a tough decision.
Buckhurst is teed up at the 35-yard line. 49ers have been advised now to be wary and be ready for the possible onside kick.
Yeah, you're right, Lindsay. The 49ers have to play for an onside kick. They can't worry about the return. They got to play for the onside kick. A lot of this right here depends on the technique of your kicker. Luckhurst coming back to his home area from Berkeley. Pressure on it. It's an onside kick. Onside kick is what it is.
They move them right. Luckhurst, left-footed, but they're trying the onside. Penalty marker goes up. Campbell is still on. There is a marker.
Well, you know,
the battle is still on down there. There's still contact being made.
He made a heck of a kick. Luckhurst made a great kick.
The man who came up with the ball was Mike Wilson.
And they had a chance to recover. They had a couple of chances to recover. He made a...
Offside. They beat the ball.
They're offside along with it. But Luckhurst did his job. He made a very difficult kick to field. Here it is. That's not a Sunday hop.
Offside. Receiving team.
There's another man had looked like Curry had a chance. But they were offside.
Receiving team offside, and so they'll have to do it all over again. Lehman Bennett saying, what is this?
Free kick.
Luckhurst now has been over there. He comes back to tee it up again.
That's a little unusual for the receiving team to be offside.
Yes.
When you send three or four guys in motion, Lindsay, usually one of those are offside.
Receiving team had a man move up and across the restraining line before it got there, and so
Martin, I think Martin was offside, 29 for the 49ers.
Well, they'll try to do it all over
again. If he could kick another one like that, they got a chance to recover. That's a tough ball to field. Not even Greg Nettles could field that one.
They move, 50-yard line to the restraining line. Kicking from the 40. Well, it takes a bounce up there, and the scramble is on. And Atlanta got it, I think. They think they got it.
I tell you, Luckhurst showed me something. I can see why they made that guy their kicker.
Apparently, they got it.
Gee.
Penalty marker across the field.
Gee, what a game.
Penalty marker across the field.
What a game. Two penalties on two.
Falcons are jubilant, but there is a marker lying on the field at the 40-yard line on the far side.
Everything relies on where that...
Offside kicking team.
Kicking team.
Gee,
so that cost them the football.
Oh. What a break. They'd have had the ball at the 40-yard line with a minute and 37 seconds to play. Gee. What drama?
Oh, my. They take it back, and they'll do it all over again.
I tell you, after seeing Luckhurst kick that ball twice like that, he can do it again. Gee.
It took that big hop you hoped for.
You know what they're talking about? Should we kick it again to the same side of the field? See? That's what they're talking about.
Yeah.
Or should we change our strategy and kick it somewhere else?
You can see it's 1:37 now. The clock starts when it's touched by a member of the receiving team in the field of play, so it only took a second that last time.
You bring the whole ball club up over here to field it. Gee.
Luckhurst the kicker, Lehman Bennett the head coach.
Everything rests on this guy. He first has to kick the right type of ball. Then he's done his job.
Take it back to the 35. That makes the restraining line to 45.
Well, looks like the strategy is changing a little bit.
It's a very deliberate motion that Luckhurst had when he reached down to get that football. Like,
yeah.
Well, one more time.
You know, I've seen him kick it all the way down there. Lindsay, kick it all the way down the field, and somebody go down and recover it.
Oh. Okay, they move. Luckhurst wasted their in position. Bounces it again. That's the restraining line. Free ball. Who's after it? Who's got it?
Jay
Latter did.
Holy,
got it at the 41-yard line.
Boy, oh boy.
Atlanta got the football at the 41-yard line.
I've never seen this in all the years.
Bennett giving instructions to his quarterback, Markowski.
Three great kicks. Hard to handle. Now the 49ers have it momentarily. Somebody has it and then loses it.
And finally, it's taken by Kenny Johnson. Kenny Johnson, number 37.
Holy
Kenny
God.
Johnson got the football. There he is.
Boy, oh boy.
All right. 1 minute, 34 seconds left. There's Luckhurst.
He should get a raise for that.
Kenny Johnson hasn't come down yet.
Oh, boy.
Ball is outside the 41-yard line. Mick Luckhurst, he has three perfect onside kicks. Three wide receivers. 3 points separate the teams. 1 minute, 34 seconds left to play in the game. Markowski going on, and he's got Jackson.
Oh!
And the save was made.
Oh!
Carlson Williamson made the save.
Got there just in time. Just in time. Jackson was waiting for the ball. He was wide open. Williamson got there just in time.
Williamson looked like the United States cavalry riding over the hill.
Dwayne Ward put the pressure on. Watch it. Just tipped it away.
Second down, 10 yards to go at the 41.
Falcons have two timeouts remaining. They don't need a touchdown. All they need is a field goal.
Field goal would send it into overtime. Three wide receivers still. Kitchens, Jackson, and Francis. Andrews, the lone setback for Markowski. Sideline veteran. It is taken down the sideline complete at the 17-yard line by Jenkins. Stops the clock as he went out of bounds. 1:23 on the clock. Alfred Jenkins.
Watch Markowski thread the needle on this. Thread the needle. Perfect pass. The defender's back is turned. Can't see it. Jenkins goes out of bounds. Here it is again. Jenkins down the sideline. 21 Eric Wright running with him. Does not see the ball. Perfect throw, good protection.
First down and 10 yards to go. Ball is at the 17-yard line. Markowski. Over the middle. Intercepted. Taken by Hicks. Right Hicks. Out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Second interception of the day. Seventh of the year.
Junior Miller on a seam pattern. Yes, Hicks was free. Was thrown to Junior Miller. He read the quarterback, made the play of the game.
Brian Hicks, the hero of the moment. Joe Montana's coming out there now. Here it is again.
Here it is. Hicks is free. He shows that he's a good free safety with his experience. He's a second-year guy. The only guy with any experience in that secondary makes a big play that may have saved the game.
49ers lead it 17-14. They have the ball first and 10 at the 20. They leave it on the ground. Joe Montana.
Boy, these last time 2 minutes. Caught. Lindsay, Falcons these last 2 minutes have been a game in the two-minute period. What Draymond on the three onside kicks, which the Falcons got two of the three.
Timeout taken by Lehman Bittens. Atlanta Falcons 1:11 showing on the clock. Time remaining. His team trails by 3 points. There are the timeouts remaining. Atlanta's got one more, and the San Francisco 49ers, of course, have all three.
They'll just have to drop on that ball. Boy, what a comeback by Atlanta. They really come back and and played the football that we've accustomed to seeing him play. You know, when you throw to your tight end down in that area, now, Sipes had the same thing happen to him against Oakland. You remember last year? That free safety, whether it's the strong safety or the free safety, down in there, there's a coverage called combination, where you're doubling that tight end inside out, and one of those guys are usually free. Hicks was free on it. He read Bartkowski perfectly, picked it off.
Second and 10 at the 20-yard line. Ball, the clock starts on the snap. Montana brings him up deliberately. Easley and Patton are the setbacks. Easley loses a yard back to the 19. Not worried about that. It's going to be third down and 9 yards to go. Timeout call by the Atlanta Falcons to stop the clock. 1:07. And that's it. They're out of timeouts. They have none remaining. Lehman Bennett pondering, what do we do with 1:07 left to play in this ball game, and we don't have the ball? It'll be third down and 9 yards to go with the ball at the 19-yard line.
Well, you know, Lindsay, one of the big things today is that the 49ers defense shut off Atlanta's running game. The last time I checked, Atlanta had about 76 yards running. Now, that's not their style. William Andrews has that much himself every ball game.
Referee has been over now to notify each coach of the number of timeouts remaining in this ball game. And it's been a barn burner in the second half here at Candlestick Park. The 49ers coming in with a two-game lead over the Rams and over Atlanta. Trying to stretch it to three and to stretch their own consecutive game streak to seven straight wins. They haven't lost a game at Candlestick at home this year. Patton has it. And he is at the 19-yard line for no game, where it'll be fourth down. Dakin in to make the tackle.
Well, they ran wide to get as much of the clock going and stayed in bounds.
So it's fourth down coming up. Clock is running, of course. They'll get all out of it they can. The 49ers will.
Atlanta will have to try to block the punt. Everybody up, 10 men up, put the punt block on. There's another thing here that the punter might do. He could take a safety if he wanted.
We'd like to welcome those of you who've been watching the Rams and New Orleans. Right here, we're in the closing moments of the ball game. 26 seconds left to play. Fourth down for the 49ers, who are leading in the game by a score of 17-14. I'm Lindsey Nelson with George Allen. We're at Candlestick Park in San Francisco. Now, delay of game. They let the clock run down as far as they could. It's 18 seconds left to play in this game. 18 seconds, and the 49ers are leading it. 3 points separate them, 17-14.
You know, Lindsey, what I have done down here, what could happen is a punter should take a safety.
Fourth down.
You see, take a safety so you don't risk having that punt blocked. Blocked punt could cost you the ball game, so take a deliberate safety. There's the interception by the free safety. He was thrown to Junior Miller.
Ryan Hicks had a key interception moments ago to give the ball to the 49ers. So now Miller on the end zone gets it out of there. Fair catch signal by Scott Warner, and he makes the fair catch at the 35-yard line. Yep. 10 seconds on the clock.
He didn't have to signal for a fair catch.
He didn't. No one was scared, but he went back and he spotted at the 36-yard line.
Well, when you have 10 men up, it's pretty hard to get a return.
So, next week, an NFL doubleheader on CBS Sports. Most of you watching this game will see Los Angeles at Cincinnati in the first game, followed by Dallas at Detroit in the second game of the doubleheader. It all begins here on CBS with the NFL today. Check your local listings for the games and times in your area. Bartkowski dropping back to put it up. Clock is running 8 seconds, 7 seconds, throws to the sideline. Incomplete. Clock is stopped. 3 seconds. Jenkins, the intended receiver. 3 seconds on the clock.
And you know who hit Bartkowski? Brett Dean, number 74. Sacked him just as he threw the ball. The 49ers pass rush today, and the rushing defense has been the difference. Bartkowski has not been able to set up and throw like he normally does. He's got time for one bomb.
They're going to spread the defense back now. They're going to send the defense. Hicks is going to deep, and they're going to spread him back. They know it'll be a bomb. fifth largest football crowd in the history of Candlestick here this afternoon to see the 49ers, and they're leading 17-14. Clock starts on the snap to Bartkowski. Bartkowski now deep. They got three receivers going down the left side. He puts it up, hoping for an interference call or what else. Incomplete. Time has run out, and the ball game is over. There is no flag. Three receivers. Defenders there. Batted incomplete. The ball game is over, and the San Francisco 49ers have stretched their lead over the Los Angeles Rams to 3, over Atlanta to 3, with 6 games to play. And what a day we had here at Candlestick Park.
Great football game, Lindsay. A great game. Went right down to the final play. That's the type of game we predicted it would be.
Bill Walsh coming off now, the head coach and general manager in his third year. Executive producer is Terry O'Neill. Senior producer is Charles H. Milton III.